love it. Knoxville campus, just 3 hours east of here. He is fired up.
Tell you what, he got me fired up. I need a helmet, chin strap, and a mouthpiece, and I'd be ready to go. I think I'd do it even without the shoulder pads.
Tyler Bird back to receive for Tennessee. Drew Brown will handle the kickoff duties for Nebraska. And we are underway in Music City. Bird 6 yards deep will take a knee, and we get to see Josh Dobbs in his final start as a volunteer. Andre, you referenced it. Through the month of November, there may not have been a better quarterback in all of college football. His last 4 games, Josh Dobbs was nearly unstoppable. Now, he had to be because their defense was porous, and they won 3 out of those 4 games.
Yeah, he's a guy that will a dual threat. Quarterback is how you describe him. He can kill you through the air. You see the 80% completion percentage the last 4 games. He can do it on the ground. He'll just cause problems all afternoon long for this Nebraska defense.
Last 4 games, Tennessee averaged 50 points a game and 548 yards of offense. Alvin Kamara on the first touch clears the left edge and is able to take it for a gain of 7. Josh Banderas, the Huskers' leading tackler, brings him down.
Yeah, he's the quarterback of this Nebraska defense. He's been a very productive player this season. Leads the team, as you mentioned, with 89 tackles on the year. Off to a pretty good start here in the bowl game.
Dobbs on play action. Finds his tight end, Kroom. And Jason Kroom gets flipped near the 40. A gain of 8. Consecutive great plays for Tennessee. Michael Rose Ivy on the stop.
Yeah, the thing about Nebraska defensively, and there's a flag down. But defensively, they're going to force you to drive the field. Very rarely do they give up big plays over the top.
It'll be a little bit tougher for them today.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 82 offense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Pac-12 crew, Michael Mothershed is our referee.
Let's go back and take a look at it. It's Ethan Wolf, the tight end, coming in a little bit late, using the helmet, definitely an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. And those are the ones that will drive head coach Butch Jones crazy. You know, you have a nice run, a first down, off to a good start, and then you commit a penalty like that to back you up.
First down regardless for Tennessee, and quarterback Josh Dobbs as they go 4 wide here. Juwan Jennings is in at quarterback here to take the direct snap. Former high school quarterback, and he takes it straight up the middle for a gain of 9. It's Antonio Reed on the tackle, and that safety spot is one that where they're missing one of their team leaders that you mentioned before. Reed is replacing Nathan Gary, who had 4 picks this year and 13 career interceptions, one off the school record set by Dana Stevenson. So that's a big miss in the back end for Nebraska. Dobbs back at QB, and he's able to find Josh Malone near the 40 to complete a first down. Chris Jones on the stop. They pick up 6.
I think Josh Malone may be the best wide receiver that I've had a chance to watch this year. Now, he only had 45 catches on the season, but boy, the potential is there. The big playmaking ability is certainly there. Great hands, excellent route runner.
And he's got a touchdown in 4 consecutive games as Tennessee finished the season with some offensive outbursts against the likes of Kentucky, Missouri, Vandy.
A lot of those close to the Tennessee program think this may be Josh Malone's last ball game as a volunteer.
Dobbs keeps it, cuts it back inside, and here he goes. The senior to the 40 with another beautiful cutback. And Josh Dobbs takes it into Husker territory, a scramble of 30 yards.
What made it go was the block by 82, Ethan Wolf. You make a mistake, you better make up for it at some point. Nice down block by 82, Ethan Wolf. That opened it up for Josh Dobbs. And I just said that, hey, this is a Nebraska team that doesn't give up big plays. This is a different quality opponent today in Tennessee.
Huskers really struggled against the run in their 3 Big Ten losses to Ohio State, Iowa, and Wisconsin. Trips to the left, Smith, Malone, and Jennings for Dobbs. Looks that way, and he's able to dump it out to Josh Smith, who stays on his feet past the 30. Nope, they'll rule him down where he made the catch. The knee was down. It's a loss of 1. Joshua Kalu was right there for Nebraska.
Let's take a look here and see if the knee indeed was down. See him go down and make a nice catch.
Elbow down. So that'll do it.
The elbow does it if the knee didn't.
First negative play for UT. Dobbs pressured, and that's a rare pressure for Nebraska on first down. It came from Carlos Davis up front. If they're going to get after the quarterback on first or second down, Nebraska will have to do it with their front four.
Yeah, they depend on the front four. I mentioned earlier, it's a group. There's really no tricks to what they do defensively. They just line up and play football. And if you're going to throw and you're going to pass, they're going to get the pass rush with the front four. They'll play a lot of zone, mix in some man coverage, but it's nothing that you haven't seen. It's just very vanilla, but they play it so well, they make it tough to move the football.
Pressure here on third and 11. Pocket holds for Dobbs. A deep ball turns around, his receiver incomplete. Kalu had to cover John Jawan Jennings.
Yeah, Kalu has been very consistent all season long. He's their boundary corner, and they don't move corners. He'll stay into the boundary. It's a lot of matchups to that side. They like to bring him at times off the edge. Well, that's just solid coverage right there. You see him looking back, trying to make a play on the football.
Trevor Daniel punted away. Tennessee playing for field position early, and the ball will be down at the 1 yard line.
Great
32
work.
Yard punt. Couldn't have done it better. Justin Martin there to down it for Tennessee.
I'll tell you, when in bowl games, especially early, special teams play a huge role. Field position, and right now, you would say advantage Tennessee with Nebraska backed up basically at their own 1 yard line.
So Riker Fife out of Grand Island, Nebraska, comes on the field to make his third career start in his final career game. Fifth-year senior, whose only offer coming out of high school was at Nebraska Kearney, a Division II school.
This is where I like to take a shot, Tom. Backed up, get back, get set, let the ball go.
Terrell Newby is his running back. They're going to run it out of the end zone. Newby breaks the plane and takes it out to the 1.5. Todd Kelly Jr. in on the stop for Tennessee.
And that's the reason why. Penetration. You heard Mike Riley talk about the front four with Derek Barnett, Vereen, all those guys up front. Well, they make plays. They get excellent penetration, recreate the line of scrimmage. When you're pinned back like this, it's tough to run the football to give yourself some breathing room. So I said, take a shot. You got nothing to lose here.
Seathan Carter, the tight end, comes in motion. Coming back from a left elbow injury. They try to run it again. And they get a little bit more space behind Newby. Honorable mention, all Big Ten running back. Brought down by Jonathan Congbo. Tennessee is a little light up front this game, as they have been all season. Demarie Mixon, a junior from Compton, California, was sent home from Nashville for a violation of team rules. They've had numerous injuries on the defensive side of the ball, especially decimated in the middle. So Congbo and Vickers should see a lot of snaps today.
I think 18 total injuries on the year for Tennessee across the board on both sides. Tough, tough to get to where they are today with that many injuries.
Third down and 8. Fife over the middle, complete to Demoyne Personnel, and he picks up a Nebraska first down on a gain of 11.
There's not a lot of film on Riker Fife, but I went back to the Maryland game and spent some time watching it, and this kept seeing this over and over again. He can buy time. He's got a quick release. You see him here, by time, quick release to get the ball out. He's very accurate, moving away from pressure, not afraid to stand in there and take a shot to deliver the football. Tell you what, this young man's not afraid of the moment.
So a fresh set of downs for the Huskers as Riley comes in motion. And Newby gets another carry but slips on the turf. Brought down by Derek Barnett. He's the story of the Tennessee defense we were telling about earlier. First consensus All-American for Tennessee since Eric Berry in 09. He is tied with the great Reggie White for the all-time school record in sacks. He's got 32, and he's the only SEC player in history to have 10 or more in three consecutive seasons.
Yeah, we got a chance to talk with Derek Barnett yesterday, Cole and I, and I know Cole likes the big fella coming off the edge.
It's a challenge for their left tackle, Nick Gates, who is looking forward to this. Third-year sophomore out of Vegas matched up with Barnett. Fife to throw on the slant, and it's incomplete. Cole, what do you like about Derek Barnett?
Well, Tom, there's a lot to like. First and foremost, it's the motor. The guy doesn't stop. He's a sideline-to-sideline player. His measurables won't add up to some of the elite edge defenders that you see around college football, but he has great flexibility, something that's not talked about with defensive linemen very much, that dip and rip that we've seen him do around the edge, a lot of speed, but body flexibility for somebody his size is what I really like about Derek Barnett off the edge.
And a quiet confidence. When you're around him, you just know you're in the presence of a guy that loves the game of football and certainly knows how to play it at a high level.
Lined up wide across from Gates. Coming to Fife's backside, he gets rid of it, incomplete to Carter. But that's what you talked about, Andre. Fife just buying a little bit of time with another half step backwards.
Yeah, and the guys on the field with him, Kathan Carter, going to have to make some plays along with Stanley Morgan on the outside. It's there. You see the screen being set up. If you can just hold on to the football, you've got running room because of the pressure. The defensive line, it's disappeared. It's in the lap of Riker Fife.
So Nebraska finally to punt it away. Cameron Sutton back to receive for Tennessee. Caleb Lightbourne handles the punting duties for the Huskers. Sutton asked for a fair catch. We'll take it at the 44-yard line. A 43-yard punt from Lightburn. Downtown Nashville, Tennessee. Beautiful day for football. First quarter continues after this. Free winner, Lamar Jackson. He had a coming out party in this bowl last year.
Yes, he did. And if LSU doesn't beware, he's proven that he can ball in bowl games. No doubt about it.
Is his room at the Heisman House ready yet, or still need to make some accommodations?
I was ready for him when he won it. You know, you have it prepared.
You just move
already.
Right in.
You just move in. Just bring your stuff.
Does everybody get their security deposit back?
No security deposit.
Second possession for Tennessee. They start with Kamara here, and he is bottled up with multiple flags on the play.
Yeah, maybe a hold on Drew Richmond, the left tackle here.
A loss of two.
Holding, number 51 offense, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Mike DeBoer pulled Drew Richmond aside as they're getting ready for bowl practice and simply said to him, you've come a long way. This is a guy early in the season who was really struggling.
There's the hole right there. You see him, almost a tackle from behind. Great job by the officials to catch that.
They have started seven different offensive line combinations this season, have the Volunteers. 8-4 season, 4-4 in SEC play. Dobbs wants to throw again. His sixth pass of the game, complete to Kamara. And Kamara tackled at the sideline by Josh Banderas. Gain of 5, second stop for Banderas.
Yeah, Tom, I think that's where they've got to go to really get this offense moving. Alvin Kamara is certainly capable of taking over a game. He needs touches. Very gifted player, excellent in space, can run between the tackles. Got to find a way to get number 6 to football. Here he is down here.
5 wide now for Tennessee. And movement on the right side, and Brett Kendrick.
Full start, number 63 offense. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
And Andre, this isn't atypical. When you've had 4+ weeks off, there will be some rust.
Especially on the offensive side of it. The defense is just kind of bite down on the mouthpiece and go attack. But, you know, so many parts have to work together on an offense. And you've been off for a couple weeks. Yeah, you've been practicing, but it's not like that normal weekly routine of getting ready for a ball game.
Third flag against the Vols. Here's Kamara. Makes the first man miss and then is brought down by a host of Huskers, including Reed coming in from that safety spot. Cole?
Tom, it's chilly down on the field, but I'm seeing a lot of frozen feet from the Nebraska linebackers. A lot of window dressing from Mike DeBoer, the Tennessee offensive coordinator early. Motions, shift changes, a lot of different things. Play fakes from Josh Dobbs. And at times, I've seen those Nebraska linebackers sort of lost in space a little bit. Concrete shoes, so to speak, not moving very well.
Also describes your dance moves on Broadway this week, Cole.
I saw him dance.
You're welcome.
He's just like the stone feet.
You know, for a dancer, Cole's a great offensive lineman. 3rd and 14 now for Tennessee. too high. And Tennessee will punt it away again. Dobbs was looking for Josh Smith.
Cole talked about window dressing for Mike DeBoard. Well, I think with field position this drive, you're going to see a lot of it from Nebraska as well. They will move, they'll shift, and then they'll run screens. They love to run the screen game, get Newby involved in it, and the ball in his hands in space. They'll run sweep, speed sweeps with Brandon Riley. A lot of movement on this Husker offense.
DeMorne Pearsonell back for Nebraska. Won't have a chance to return here. A shank from Trevor Daniel. We'll see how far they walk it up. We've got a flag on the play near the Tennessee sideline. The punt is marked at the 37. 22-yard punt for Daniel.
I believe Mike Riley, if it's against Tennessee, it's going to be offsides against Nebraska. And an opportunity for
offside.
Some great field position.
Number 26 defense, 5-yard penalty, replay, fourth down.
There's some great field position blown there. Right there.
Kyren Williams. So, try it again.
Keep your eye on him. He's had 3 blocked punts in his career. Excellent special teams player.
Whoa! Daniel booms this one all the way out of the back of the end zone. That was a rocket, a 54-yarder. You know, the second guy off the tee is always better. 6.5
well
to
again.
Go. Yes, in this first quarter, no score.
All right. The town has this energy.
In just 3 years, Derek Barnett established himself as one of the best rush-ins in Tennessee history and comparable to the best in college football, especially as you consider this summer's NFL draft. Here's how he matches up with Myles Garrett of Texas A&M. Now keep in mind, all 12 of Barnett's sacks this season came against conference opponents.
I'll tell you what, well, not just this season, but in SEC history, one of the best to ever get it done is Derek Barnett. 29 of his 32 against SEC opponents. He's doing it against the big boys.
He's from right here in Nashville, Brentwood Academy. Home game for him. And for Nebraska, a gain of 2 for Newby on first down. But there's been very little consistency with this Tennessee defense, unless you want to say they were consistently bad, especially late in the year. 26 sacks, tied for 60. That's the best number they have. One of the worst defenses overall in total yards and gashed on the ground through the month of November especially. They allowed 600 yards plus in each of their last 3 games against Kentucky, Missouri, and Vanderbilt. Not exactly offensive powerhouses. On 2nd and 7, Newby straight ahead. And he's got a first down. McDowell will finally wrestle him to the ground after a gain of 9. Second first down for Nebraska today.
Yeah, and those things will happen defensively when you start looking at all the players that are out for Tennessee. But here, watch Newby. They've got a little gap here, and he's able to break some tackles. He's not a big back at 5'10", about 200 pounds, but he does run between the tackles well. He's a jump cut runner, can get from one hole to the other in a hurry.
Devine Ozigbo is in the backfield with them for the first time today. And Ozigbo, who's been injured over the back half of the season, is able to pick up 5 yards before McDowell brings him down.
He's the big bruiser. Get tough, get physical. They bring the big fella in and let him go to work. But my point on Tennessee defensively is 11 different secondary combinations because of injuries, 7 different linebacker combinations because of injuries, and the only 2 on the defensive line, actually Kendall Vickers, Vereen, and Barnett, were the only defensive linemen to start every game this year. So there's a lot of moving pieces for Tennessee defensively.
On 2nd and 5, they give it to Newby. He's able to find a hole and will be a yard short of the first down. That's going to bring up 3rd and 1. Nebraska knows injuries, certainly missing some playmakers in this game for Tennessee. That injury bug was around all season. 10 different defensive back starting combinations in 12 games for Tennessee.
Some linebackers, D-line certainly, and then the offensive line, where offensively that's where you're going to get the work done. Eight different combinations up front, and you can't get the continuity that you need to be consistent from week to week.
Two tight ends to the left, Carter and Cotton. Third and one. Cornerback sneak with Riker Fife, and he picks it up.
My favorite play. Why mess around taking it 5-7 yards deep to give it to a back and allow for penetration? More coaches should watch that play right there in short yardage situation. Love it. Got a big 6'3 quarterback. Get behind a big offensive line, get some push, and let's move on. Don't understand trying to outsmart. It just being the smartest guy in the stadium.
Did you check your soapbox, or they let you carry that on?
I'm still standing on it, pounding the table now.
First down for Nebraska, the first end around of the jet sweep. Stanley Morgan Jr., no gain. It's a big part of their game, trying to get their slot involved in the running game, because Mike Riley does a great job, as you pointed out, Andre, of making you defend the width of the field.
Yeah, they'll do this. They'll window dress. They'll give you a bunch formations away from it, motion to it, throw the screen game, and then run the speed sweeps. And this guy here is talented. 2015 newcomer of the year on this football team, or the team's newcomer of the year. Tell you what, he has a very bright future for this Husker football program.
Here's Newby, and he gets popped in the backfield, but stays on his feet, trying to get to the edge. Fife tried to throw him a block, and finally popped out of bounds by Cameron Sutton. Todd Kelly Jr. was the first man there. It'll be a loss of three for Terrell Newby.
Well, you got a shot to basically clean somebody up, and you're Riker Fife. They'll clean you up. You have to throw a block in this situation. Todd Kelly misses a tackle, but watch him peel back here. You got to throw that block. You can't swing and miss. You got to make some contact.
Third down, 13. Nebraska's converted 2 of 3 third downs already today.
Where's the big guy? There he is. Eric Barnett.
Fife dumps it off to Newby. Incomplete. Little bit behind. Barnett was bringing pressure. Cole, I know you can hear a lot down there. Derek Barnett is not shy today for a guy who's a quiet leader. He's talking a heck of a lot.
Tom, I love it. Derek Barnett, a little chippy between every single play I've seen him on the field. He's standing back in the Nebraska offensive huddle when they were backed up near the end zone here earlier. This kid is showing me a lot today. He wants to go out a winner, and he's bringing it not only with his play, but maybe with the chops as well.
He just told Nick Gates, the left tackle, you cannot block me. And certainly one-on-one, Nick Gates might need a little help.
Nick Gates compared him to Shalik Calhoun, the Michigan State great who's now in the NFL. He said the difference is Barnett's stronger. And what a strong punt that time from Caleb Lightbourne. A 49-yarder, which is going to back Tennessee up inside the 10. Not much offense thus far today in Nashville, but plenty of chatter. You give Derek Barnett a pop. He's... Two tradition-rich programs meet here. Nebraska, owners of 5 national titles between Bob Devaney and Tom Osborne, their last coming in 97. 46 conference championships.
3 fraternity brothers.
Yes. Johnny Rogers, Mike Rozier, and Eric Crouch.
All good guys.
We were talking about it. Nebraska as a program is one that had so much success recruiting nationally, especially getting their stars from coast to coast. Here's John Kelly with his first carry. Tommy Frazier, maybe the best quarterback in all of college football history, from Bradenton, Florida. He never won the Heisman, but helped him to a national championship. And Andre, I know you pointed it out, coast to coast put some pins in a map. That's what made Tom Osborne and that staff so successful.
No doubt about it. Way back when, they were recruiting nationally, and talked to Mike Riley about that this past week, and said that's what they want to do. They've got commits from California down in Texas, a couple in Louisiana. He wants to kind of refine that blueprint that Tom Osborne took to really build this program.
57 on the roster from the Husker State. Incomplete off the hands of Jawan Jennings, and that's going to leave 3rd and 4.
This coaching staff for Tennessee, they were really pleased with Jawan Jennings and his development. You mentioned it, high school quarterback, but just to the development as a wide receiver and how fast he transitioned to start to make plays and contribute in games as a young player has been phenomenal.
Tennessee 0 for 2 on third downs today. Five wide and an empty backfield for Dobbs. Remember, he is a great runner.
What's Akin Mullen doing? Number 91 here.
Nebraska drops. That one is incomplete. Alvin Kamara had only Green in front of him, but he couldn't bring it in.
We usually don't see that. We got zone blitz going. They go with Freedom Akin Mullen. Drop him out. Watch 91 peel himself back and as well. Number 5, Dedrick Young, trying to peel back as well, give it the look of blitz. And by then, Kamara with the speed was behind everybody. And just could not hold on to it.
Trevor Daniel had a boomer last time, a 54-yarder. DeMornay Pearsonell back to receive. No return for the Huskers. And down by Mosley after a 51-yarder. Bowl season continues Monday with 3 bowl games at 1 p.m. Eastern. The Goodyear Cotton Bowl, number 15, Western Michigan, and 8th-ranked Wisconsin. At 5 p.m., it's the Rose Bowl, presented by Northwestern Mutual. Number 9, USC versus number 5, Penn State. And at 8:30, the All-State Sugar Bowl, number 14, Auburn, number 7, Oklahoma. All three games also streaming live in the ESPN app and watch ESPN.
We'll look for Nebraska to get Newby going downhill. They've had a taste of this Tennessee speed moving laterally.
8th carry of the day for Newby. He's bottled up. And a host of defenders able to bring him down. Corey Green and Latroy Lewis. And it's a gain of 1.
So quick and powerful inside. Look at Vickers, who's getting tremendous penetration. Latroy Lewis, who's fought injuries basically all season long, has been a full-time starter at times in his career. But what he is vastly improved this year on the outside.
Be honest, this looks like an entirely different Tennessee defense today than what we saw late in the regular season. Five trying to set up the screen. He's able to get it to Newby with a sidearm toss, but no gain. This is a Tennessee defense which over the last 3 SEC games, 3 of the last SEC opponents rushed for at least 400 yards, and they have allowed 10 100-yard rushers over the course of the season.
No, and they're tackling well. And we talked to Butch Jones about that, and he said we did more tackling in this bowl practices than ever before. They did a lot of good versus good, a lot of ones-on-ones, but they tackled in this bowl practice period, and it's showing up here early against Nebraska's offense.
Third down, 9. Movement along Nebraska's right side may have been Cole Conrad, who shares time at right tackle.
Full start. Number 62 offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down. Please reset the game clock to 3 seconds.
The senior starter at center, he's a little bit upset. He's a team captain. He was trying to get to the sideline to relay a message to the coaching staff, but upset. The big guy inside, number 66.
Yeah, that's Dylan Utter, former walk-on turn captain. Mike Riley in his second season as a head man since coming over from Oregon State. But Jones has to use a timeout. Tennessee wasn't prepared with 3 seconds left, and that'll be the end of the quarter. And it's Nebraska but Riker Fife and the offense on the field looking at third and long, and Tennessee didn't have the personnel to match. So we are one quarter in, and the offense has been late to the party here in Nashville. Nebraska out of the Big Ten and Tennessee out of the SEC, scoreless through 1 at Nissan Stadium. There's the great Tommy Frazier.
Good one. Well, the best I've ever seen play the game, Tommy Frazier.
A lot of similarities between these programs. They each had a run, 3 decades plus. Johnny Majors and Philip Fulmer celebrating that great Tennessee heritage. 1998 national championship with T. Martin, Bob Devaney and Tom Osborne, 5 national titles, 21 conference titles. But since they lost their patriarchs in many ways, They've had a hard time returning to glory. Four head coaches, Kiffin, Dooley, Cheney, and now Jones for Tennessee. Same for Nebraska, Solich, Callahan, Pelini, and now Riley. I think this season, Andre, a great example for both as to how hard it is to recapture that glory. Tennessee started 5-0, top 10,
yep.
Fell by the wayside. Nebraska started 7-0, top 10,
Got to give coaches time to build programs. Impatient alums contribute to that.
And you got to stay healthy. Riker, Fife, former walk-on quarterback, pressure by Derek Barnett, who's strutting around in the Nebraska backfield.
Well, he is talking to Fife. He's talking to Nick Gates. And this is all while we have players sitting out games. Derek Barnett embraced it. He wanted to play in this game. You can see emotionally that he is dialed in to playing in this bowl game, his final as a Tennessee Volunteer, but he is certainly engaged today.
Should be a first round pick. Cameron Sutton back to receive for Tennessee. They've got 10 on the line. And a good looking punt from Lightbourne. Sutton with a fair catch at the 26-yard line, a 42-yard punt. This college football season, you can stream every game live on the ESPN app and on Watch ESPN. Simply download the app or visit watchespn.com today. You think Derek Barnett has anything more to prove to NFL GMs and scouts?
I think he just loves playing the game. And it's not about proving, because I think he knows that he's a dynamic playmaker and can certainly get to the quarterback. He can defend the run. I'll tell you what, Cole, you like him. Tell me a little bit about Derek Barnett.
He was never an option for him. He told us after practice yesterday, Andre, he wants to play football. He said, I love the game. I respect the game. I have something to prove to myself, my teammates, and my fans, and not disrespecting Tennessee football to skip this game.
And that's a reference to the entire fan base in the entire state. Dobbs over the middle, complete to Malone. First big play of the game, goes for 31. Chris Jones with the tackle on the back end.
And that right there is one of the reasons why I say this may be the best receiver I've had a chance to see this year. You see him set the defensive back, Chris Jones, up. Nice eight route on a post, driving right at him, and then finishes it.
Dobbs has time again, goes to the outside. This time it's Jawan Jennings, who gets dropped by Michael Rose Ivy.
They've got some playmakers on the outside. Jennings, big physical receiver, and then Malone on the other side, who can take the top off of defense. I think his speed is very, very much underrated.
Bird in motion. On play action, Dobbs looking for Kamara. And Kamara gets taken down immediately by safety Antonio Reed, only a gain of 3.
Yeah, he's a very physical player, Antonio Reed. And that's just a heck of a job against a good player in Kamara. Nice open field tackle. Because if he misses that tackle, it's off to the races. We got a track meet. We're standing in for Nathan Jerry, the team captain and leader in terms of tackles, or second of tackles on this Husker defense. Antonio Reed has done a nice job here early for Nebraska.
Second down, 7. Here's Kelly. Kelly has a first down run in the sideline. 28-yard touchdown run for the sophomore from Detroit City.
We talked about it. They don't give up very many big plays, but when you start missing leadership, Nathan Gary on the back end, we'll see here. They get caught inside, and the speed of John Kelly, who was an electric player. He was the third back on this team when the season started. In about midseason, started to get more time and has made the most of it.
Nearly half of Kelly's yards have come in the last 3 games of the season, a 4-play, 73-yard scoring drive. Aaron Medley on for the point after. Parker Henry is the holder. Took a little bit for Tennessee to find the rhythm, but a big pass to Malone, and then a long run from John Kelly. 28 yards up the left sideline, and Tennessee strikes first in Music City. Volunteers up 7-0. start this year. Bad losses in SEC play on the road at South Carolina and Kentucky. Losses on the road at Texas A&M at home against Alabama, the number one team in the country. Kickoff goes into the end zone and a touchback. These two tradition-rich programs meeting in a bowl for the third time. Two recognized national championships, the AP and Coaches Poll and the BCS, General Nealon in 51, Philip Fulmer in 98, 13 SEC titles and 23 College Football Hall of Famers, the most in the Southeastern Conference. What all of that means in many ways is that the expectations are high.
Oh, yeah.
The top.
And they should be. You have such rich traditions and a lot of winning in the past. You should have high expectations for your program.
Nebraska has had seven first downs. They've run it all seven times, and they're averaging less than a yard and a half on first down. The Huskers, somewhat vanilla offensively. Do they need to spice it up to have success against Tennessee?
I think so. You've got to try to push the ball down the field. The problem is Tennessee can get pressure with just those front four. Mike Riley talked about it when his early game hit with Cole, that was his concern, is the guys up front, the front four of Tennessee, can wreak a lot of havoc.
So behind the chains here on second and a long 10. Fife going deep. And Reimers has it, pardon me, Brandon Riley has it go off of his fingertips. Rashawn Galden with the coverage for Tennessee. And not a good sign that Brandon Riley is slow to get to his feet.
Yeah, they like to use him. They'll use him on end arounds and speed sweeps. He's got a lot of plays for him in the package. Here he just mistimes it. Turns and just mistimed the ball. He actually had a better route to it than Galden, the defensive back. He just mistimed it and got out in front of it a little bit too much.
And that was not a very soft landing. It looked like his helmet bounced off the grass field here at Nissan Stadium. Third and 11. Five wide receivers, five pressure. Sidearms one incomplete. Just a bit behind Seathan Carter, their fine tight end. And the Huskers will have to punt it away.
Looked like Jonathan Kongbo with the pressure to get there. He and Barnett, but Kongbo inside at defensive tackle. We'll see Barnett again. I mean, barely getting a hand on him. He flushes him up. I think Kongbo kind of gets him a shout on Riker Fife. They had to do a little convincing the latter part of the season for Kongbo to move inside the defensive tackle, and he's finally embraced it, and is starting to show up in his play.
Fair catch for Cameron Sutton.
Good punt.
43 yards off the foot of Lightbourne. 12:20 to go before half here in Nashville.
Grew up with that Friday night Houston wrestling with Paul Bosch. Me and my great-grandmother. Yes, indeed.
I am not surprised that your grandma is a pro wrestling fan.
She was. Yes, bless her heart.
Taught you how to fish and taught you how to figure four. Here's Kamara off the left side. He's had a hard time getting it going against this Nebraska defense. And Josh Banderas escorts him out of bounds after a gain of one.
Yeah, you're going to have to play leverage defense a little bit better if you're Nebraska. Stop giving. They gave up one big run to John Kelly that ended up in the end zone. Kamara certainly capable of getting the edges. Can't give up leverage from outside in and expect to contain the speed of Tennessee.
Dobbs wants to throw. Jennings comes back to him, picks up the first down. The shy of midfield on a gain of 12. Rose Ivy and company with the stop.
Yeah, good patience by Josh Dobbs. Deep zone drops by this Nebraska defense. There's going to be a lot of underneath routes available for Josh Dobbs, and there he's able to find Jennings. But you see the soft coverage on the back end back here.
Kelly back in at tailback for Tennessee. Dobbs Hands it off to Kelly on the delay, and he's able to pick up a first down. Gain of 10 on first down.
See here, make it look like pass. Boy, that was set up just right. And fighting the defensive line up the field. And with those soft zone drops that I just talked about, nice and deep. So plenty of running room for Kelly and Kamara.
They're going to reverse it with Tyler Byrd. Byrd doesn't get the block he needed on the edge, but he's able to push his way through a tackle for a gain of 9.
A classic case of so much time off and really not tackling. You forget to wrap up. They have Byrd wrapped, basically hemmed in right here. You can't just expect Chris Jones to knock him down. You've got to bring your hands along with your body.
Volunteers threatening again. Second and 1. Dobbs. And he is popped for a loss of 1. Williams comes up to make this stop for Nebraska.
A couple of nice tackles. Williams, Antonio Reed, two young safeties, both sophomores on the back end for Nebraska. Big down here to get themselves off the field. Keep in mind that soft zone coverage, experienced quarterback like Dobbs will find it. No need to.
Nope. Kelly's able to pick it up with his feet on a gain of 3. Banderas piling up the tackles, but it comes after a UT first down.
Really starting to reestablish the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball, defensively, the defensive line of Tennessee, as well as now the offensive line of the Volunteers starting to take over a little bit here.
Nebraska only gave up 141 yards a game on the ground during the course of the season, but their 3 losses, they really had a tough time against top competition stopping the run. Dobbs trying to stay alive. He does! And on the escape, he fires incomplete. Coverage on the back end from Chris Jones. They close down on Ethan Wolf.
Well, he really does throw a pretty ball, but watch the footwork and his ability to escape defenders. I mean, he's basically tackled at one point here. Should have been tackled right there. He does a nice job of getting himself, buying some more time, getting outside the pocket. And that's a win offensively by not taking the sack and just throwing the football away.
Alvin Kamara on the 8th play of the drive. Rose Ivy meets him, gain of 2.
This is more along the lines of what you see when you turn the film on all year for Nebraska. A lot of guys around the football making plays, trying not, you know, not allowing the offense to really get itself going.
They've been a great takeaway team over the course of the season, but most of those came from Nathan Gary, who had 2 picks late in the game in the overtime loss against Wisconsin. Kelly rejoins Dobbs in the backfield. Looking for the screen to the left, not there. Dobbs will improvise. Josh Dobbs all the way down inside the 15-yard line. A 14-yard rumble for the 6'3", 210-pound senior.
And once again, you lose leverage, you lose contain. Dedrick Young, who's twisting all the way around, he is the guy that's supposed to keep Josh Dobbs bottled up inside.
And now Kelly for 4.
Let's go back and take one more look at this. Watch number 5, Young. You'll see him flash into your screen right there. His job is to keep Josh Dobbs bottled in where all the help is and not lose leverage and contain outside. Once he does, it's easy for an athlete like Joshua Dobbs.
Nebraska shows pressure. They rarely bring it up first and second down, but they come with Rose Ivy. Dobbs straight ahead to the 1 and in. Josh Dobbs extends it across the goal line for a 10-yard touchdown run.
Well, when he gets locked in, he's a special, special player. We'll see him here. This is a double move, a pump and go. And once it breaks down, the athletic ability to still pull it down and make plays and get himself into the end zone. Special player.
11 play, 66-yard drive. Took 4:44 off the clock for Tennessee. And of those 66 yards, 23 came on the ground from quarterback Josh Dobbs. In his final game as a Tennessee quarterback, Josh Dobbs has led Tennessee to a 2-touchdown lead on Nebraska, his 10th rushing touchdown of the season. Hondridge Holloway, both fantastic runners in their days.
You talked to Butch about this before, Butch Jones, about how he basically kind of trained his thoughts on the quarterback position with Josh Dobbs. He wanted a high completion guy. That just wasn't Josh Dobbs early in his career, but it certainly has been as of late.
Flag on the play with the kick out of bounds. .736 to go before the half here at Nissan Stadium in Asheville. Let's check in with Reese Davis.
Tom, thank you very much. The studio update brought to you by Royal Caribbean. The AutoZone Liberty Bowl, Georgia and TCU. Freshman Jacob Eason finding Sony Michel. Dogs very effective in the second half. They go on to win it 31-23. Back to you, Tom.
All right, Reese, thanks. A win in Kirby Smart's first year as the head coach after replacing Mark Richt in the Classic City. Hasn't been a great postseason for the SEC thus far. Tennessee trying to turn that trend around with Georgia today. Here's Newby, and Newby's able to take off for a gain of 11.
Those are the types of plays that they're going to have to get things going offensively. I think Keithan Carter as well can help this offense out along with Stanley Morgan, but playmaker is going to have to step up here for Nebraska.
That is the first time today Nebraska has thrown the ball on first down. It pays off for the Huskers. Divine Ozigbo is in at tailback. Pearsonell in motion. On play action, Fife has plenty of time. Throws on the run, and it is incomplete. Trying to find Pearsonell, but Malik Foreman broke it up.
Just a good play defensively by Foreman. Looks on the football. Exactly the timing, and he comes up limping a little bit. But watch the coverage on this. Excellent route. The timing's there. Ball's thrown out in front. Foreman just makes a nice play.
Riker Fife has had a hard time finding his rhythm against this Tennessee defense, as you see Foreman tended to. Fife has started this game 3-for-10 for 21 yards. Ozigbo able to pick up a pair on the left side. Kyle Phillips the stop for Tennessee.
We'll go with the more physical runner inside in Ozigbo to just maybe move the pile a little bit. Get some breathing room on third down so you can convert and then move the chains, make it a little bit of more manageable situation on third down here for Riker Fife.
It's third and eight. And a first sack of the day for Tennessee comes from LaTroy and Lewis. And it was after Barnett had dropped in coverage.
An unselfish player in Barnett. Just kind of does whatever it is Bob Shoops needs him to do, the defensive coordinator, and that really freed up LaTroy Lewis. I mean, just a free run on the quarterback. You see the zone drop by Barnett to the right side. So much attention is given to him that it just freed up things for Lewis on the weak side.
Lightbourne gets it away. Sutton will ask for another fair catch and takes it at the 21-yard line. On a cool, crisp Friday afternoon in downtown Nashville, Volunteers lead by 2 touchdowns.
It's the
academically ineligible, tied for second in school history in picks in Jordan Westerkamp, second in school history in receiving receptions and fourth in yards, and then Antonio Reed just moments ago, who's taken Gary's spot at safety, carted off back to the Nebraska locker room. Aaron Williams, a sophomore from Atlanta, Georgia, will slide into his spot in the Nebraska secondary.
Well, Reed had a solid first half going for himself.
It's down for Josh Dobbs in Tennessee. Four-man rush. Dobbs finds Kamara out of the backfield, but he drops it. Well, Josh Dobbs on the last possession for Tennessee, two big runs, including a touchdown run. And he's now one of three quarterbacks in Southeastern Conference history with 15 passing touchdowns and 10 rushing touchdowns in multiple seasons. Heisman winner Tim Tebow and Cowboys quarterback Dak Prescott from Mississippi State. That is pretty good company for Josh Dobbs, who, by the way, accepted an invitation to play in the Senior Bowl, and he is thrilled to do that to chase his professional dream. Dobbs, through the right side, is able to pick up three. What can Josh Dobbs show the scouts and GMs at the Senior Bowl, Cole?
Well, I think he can show what kind of an arm he has, what kind of a human he is, which we all know. Interesting human being, but an excellent guy. I think he has durability, mobility. He's shown that. But how accurate can he be down the field? I talked to Phil Savage, director of the Senior Bowl, this morning, and he said, I think people will be impressed with his arm strength and accuracy down the field. He needs to prove that he can operate in a pro-style offense. Hasn't done that collegiately.
He completed 80% of his passes over the last four regular season games. Malone hauls one in for a gain of 10.
I laugh when people say that. He operates in a pro-style offense. Who does these days? You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
I mean, who's in a drop-back system these days? So they all have to prove it.
Well, obviously something has to translate. I mean, I think Dak Prescott is a great example. Here's Smith. Hurdles a man and takes off down the sideline. Josh Smith with a 14-yard catch and run. Little Edwin Moses move up the sideline.
A chance to visit with his father before the game. You know, a good player for Tennessee for a long time. A lot of injuries, had to battle through a lot of injuries this season included, but a solid player.
And right over the top of Lamar Jackson. They're going to reverse it to Smith.
Oh, boy.
And he's thrown for a
nice
big
play.
Loss. Ross deserves with his first big play today for the Nebraska D. It's a loss of 17.
He's not a big guy, but he is a solid technician at his position. 6'3", 255, a good edge rusher, and you see him stay at home. That's the leverage I'm talking about from outside in, where you don't allow that play to get outside of you. Otherwise, it could turn itself into a big play.
Generous spot with the forward progress. It's a loss of 12, not 17. And Dobbs fires. Oh, almost picked off by Kalu, who already has one pick this season. And this Nebraska secondary has been their strength with 16 picks on the season.
Two fumble recoveries and plus five in turnover margin. You see here, this one just gets away from Dobbs, but a nice play on the back end by Kalu.
The secondary has a knack of scoring when they get their hands on a ball.
Need something positive here defensively.
They bring four on third and long. Dobbs dumps it to Jennings. And he's cut down in the open field by Kalu, a gain of 15. And that'll bring up fourth down for Tennessee.
Butch Jones chose to punt the opening drive. So they moved close to this position earlier in the game and had some positive results.
So on fourth and sixth, they'll punt it away again. DeMornay Pearsonell back for Nebraska. Daniels had a couple of boomers. He also had a shank that he was bailed out of with a penalty. That's a beauty. And it goes over the top of DeMornay L, a 47-yard punt. 2:48 to go in the second quarter. Number 21 Tennessee on top of Nebraska 14-0. Tom Hart alongside Heisman Trophy winner, College Football Hall of Famer Andre Ware. It's kind of playing out as we expect, and Nebraska is a great second half and fourth quarter team. So they're just kind of playing it slow as they do.
Yeah, they do. I mean, they make you earn it. But they've given up a couple of big plays in this game to Tennessee. It's uncharacteristic of Nebraska and how they do things. Then offensively, they really haven't gotten themselves going where they can make work or do work between tackles, then work the edges and get plays going on the outside, spread you out, and then run newbie again between the tackles. It's been really on their heels the entire ball game.
They throw on first down for the second consecutive time, and it's another big one. Seaton Carter, the tight end, in the Tennessee territory on a 31-yard strike from Fife.
Well, we talked about him maybe helping this Nebraska offense out along with Newby, but they run the crosser with him, and it's right on time. You'll see him here start inside, then back to the corner. And that ball is thrown with great timing to give him a chance to make yardage after the catch.
First time across midfield for the Huskers. Gates may have gotten away with a hold. Here's Ethan Carter, the tight end, end around, and he's flipped for a gain of 10. Well, it's going to be just shy of a first down. Take a look at what Nick Gates does as Barnett gets spun around.
Well, you see him here working against Barnett, but That's a hold. But you know my theory. You know my theory, though. It's not speeding unless you get pulled over.
That's so true. I've ridden with you. Second and one after the fine run by Carter. Fife looking deep down the sideline. Great coverage. What a catch! Brandon Riley, touchdown!
Number one, it's nice to see Brandon Riley back in the ball game after leaving with an injury early, but he meets Emmanuel Mosley and the throw. Sometimes you just have to throw guys open. That throw by Riker Fife was on the money.
We have a flag down. Pac-12 crew, Michael Mothershed is our referee.
The result of the play is a touchdown. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 9, defense, 15-yard penalty. That penalty will be enforced on the kickoff. That's the first unsportsmanlike conduct foul for number 9.
And that's notable because if Derek Barnett gets a second, his Tennessee career likely come to an end. He'd be ejected early. What a grab, though, by Brandon Riley. His first touchdown catch of the season for the senior out of Lincoln Southwest High School, and Fife with his third touchdown pass. Well, Nebraska decided to open up, and it paid off. They threw it on first down. They got the run for Carter, and then Fife goes deep. And the point after is good from Drew Brown. Brandon Riley is a four-time academic all-conference performer. Here in his final game, he's showing what he can do against great coverage from Emmanuel Mosley. Riley, a hometown kid, hauls in the first touchdown of the season, and Nebraska behind Riker Fife is on the board in Music City. Just a few moments from the Buick Halftime Report with Reese Davis, Joey Galloway, and David Pollack. They'll break down the Fiesta Bowl matchup nightmares, take a look at the Peach Bowl, and highlights from today's bowls, including Georgia's win the other side of the state in Memphis at the Liberty Bowl. No return after the Derek Barnett unsportsmanlike penalty.
Well, that puts Nebraska right back in this ball game. They did something before the half, and able to find Brandon Riley, who ran one heck of a route. A little double move, a little stutter and go on the outside, and he couldn't have been laid out there any better by Riker Fife.
.136 remaining in a half.
Well, you need your defense to step up with this time remaining here before halftime. You can't afford to give Josh Dobbs any points here before going in the locker room. Need a stop, maybe even a stop, get the ball back and try to steal a field goal before the half ends.
Tennessee's already run for 125 yards today. Dobbs to Malone for a first down for Tennessee on a strike of 15 yards.
This kid just catches everything. Everything thrown his way. Only reason why he doesn't have more catches, they don't utilize him enough, in my opinion.
Four-man rush again. A wobbler to the sideline and incomplete, trying to find Jawan Jennings.
He's trying to work the sidelines to preserve some time where you get the catch and step out of bounds. But with three timeouts and 1:16, clock's going to stop. When you move the chains on first downs, there's plenty of time to put together a drive.
Dobbs the edge again and through the hands of Jennings, too high for the 6'3 sophomore. And now all of a sudden Tennessee facing a 3rd and 10. Nebraska has all their timeouts remaining with 1:13 left and a half.
Well, you're thinking maybe steal one here if you can get off the field on third down.
This would be one of the rare times Nebraska would bring pressure. Let's see if they do. They back off, only a four-man rush. Dobbs over the middle to Kamara. He is free for a Tennessee first down.
That's the chance and the gamble you run when you drop so deep, and a guy like Kamara who can catch and run, only need 10 yards, he can hit a gear and get it for you.
Under a minute to go in the half. Dobbs finds Kamara. Kalu closing on him. And Kamara steps out of the tackle, but brought down by Shoelace. And Kalu is really banged up. Joshua Kalu, the junior from Houston, playing in that Nebraska secondary, and he got banged up two plays ago.
Might sound unfair, but that's exactly who I would throw at right now if I'm Dobbs. He's limping around. I mean, even in zone coverage, whatever area he is on the field, that's where I'm going.
Kalu shows blitz on 2nd and 2. Here he comes. Dobbs eludes him and another. Joshua Dobbs has a first down, plenty more. He will get out of bounds to stop the clock on a 14-yard scramble.
When you saw Kalu beat Drew Richmond, a corner, get around the corner, turn the edge, you see it here. Now you just got to make a play. You can't swing and miss because you make the defense vulnerable to a big play like that from a running quarterback with the skills of Josh Dobbs.
Dobbs and Tennessee trying to answer the Nebraska score. Jawan Jennings inside the 20.
I'll take a timeout here.
Coach Jones does so with 30 seconds left on the clock here in the first half.
First charge timeout. 30-second timeout.
The games we've been waiting all season for are almost here. The college football playoff semifinals are tomorrow on ESPN. It starts at 3 o'clock in Atlanta, the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl between number 4 Washington, number 1 Alabama. Then at 7, number 3 Ohio State, number 2 Clemson face off in the PlayStation Fiesta Bowl. You got any Peach Bowl tickets for me? I know you were there last year.
I don't. I was there last year. A good reason to be there. My alma mater was winning that ball game and played very well.
2nd and 2 coming out of this timeout for Tennessee. What a backbreaker it would be for Nebraska's defense to allow to score here after Fife just put them on the scoreboard.
We talked a little bit about that before this drive started. You had the mindset of, hey, let's go get some points of our own. Let's stop Tennessee, get the football back and put it back in the hands of Riker Fife and maybe steal a field goal. Now you're hoping to just give up a field goal attempt at this point.
A 3rd and 10 conversion to Alvin Kamara was a big one on this series. Nebraska was set to get the ball back. trips to the left for Dobbs with Kamara in the backfield. The Alabama transfer is taken down after a gain of five, but a Tennessee first down.
Just wanted to make sure they picked up the first down, and clock will stop. We want to get this baby snapped.
Dobbs looking in zone, fires. Caught! Juwan Jennings with a flag. Threading the needle right past Chris Jones. And the Volunteers add to their lead on a 13-yard scoring strike.
Oh, what a throw. The position of where he put the ball down low with great coverage, or you got a defender draped over your receiver. The only way he's going to make the catch is to put it low in front.
Number eight, defense. That penalty is declined. The result of the play is a touchdown.
Take a look and tell me if Juwan Jennings had control of this.
No, I think that ball touched. This may, every play is reviewed. They may take a look, buzz down and take a look at this one. You see the nose of the ball. I think the first angle would have been the better angle.
Jim Northcott is our replay
official. The ruling on the field is a touchdown. The previous play is under review.
We have Dale Newhouse, Pac-12 supervisor of officials, who's been itching to get on camera and on air with us today. Dale, we talk about controlling a catch and a ball hitting the ground. Now walk us through this. The ball can touch the ground if the receiver has control of it. Did you see control in this situation?
It looks to me like there might be a problem with the ball touching the ground, and we do look for control by the receiver. I think the replay people have a challenge here. I'm going to guess this is going to stand.
It was ruled a touchdown on the field and a completion to Jennings. The flag was on defensive pass interference. What did you see on that replay?
I don't know. That one looks like the ground's kind of helping him reel it in. And this one, I think this will be just a couple of shots, a couple of different looks there. I think it's an incompletion. It's close. It is close. But I don't think he had full control of it until it hits the ground. So we'll get an answer here pretty quick.
Dale, what is the replay crew looking for in that situation? Are they watching the ball, his hands, or both?
They're trying to determine if the hands are underneath the ball with control. And if they can't get a good look at this, it will stand. That's where I'm feeling they are right now.
Mm. Michael Mothershed, the referee. Jim Northcutt, the replay official, along with Dan Antionetti, communicator in the booth.
That's how it looks in real time and how fast they have to make that call. That's tough. And then when you slow it down and you get to take a look at it.
And then he turns his back.
I'm with you, Andre. I think that last one is a great indicator.
They're going to turn it over. They're going to overturn it.
Dale has two roles with the side. He's actually wearing two headsets right now, so he can hear what they're doing in the replay booth. Here's the call.
After review, the pass was not completed. The ball touched the ground. However, pass interference on number eight. The foul occurred in the end zone. By rule, the ball will be placed at the 2-yard line, first and goal.
So 14 seconds left, two timeouts. Yeah. How many plays is Tennessee looking at here from the 2-yard line?
Well, you got at least two, and you can run the football. I think minimum of two, maximum of about three. And depending on if you're throwing on all three downs, it's certainly three plays. You mix in a run, you're going to limit it one shy of that. I just never really felt like you saw the nose of the ball touch without him having full control of it, which is why I felt like they would overturn that baby.
John Kelly in the backfield with Josh Dobbs, 14 seconds left in the half. Dobbs will take it himself. And his second rushing touchdown of the day from 2 yards out this time.
Made it look easy. Pretty much untouched into the end zone. And has to, in his last game as a Volunteer, go out with a bang.
He's already the leading rusher for a Tennessee quarterback in school history. And he now has 11 rushing touchdowns on the season. Tennessee is able to answer the Nebraska score with a 9-play, 75-yard drive. And it's back to a 2-touchdown advantage for the Volunteers.
Just quarterback run all the way. And nice job there by Jason Kroon, who really finished the latter part of the season on an upswing at tight end for Tennessee. Got more playing time down the stretch. Threw a nice block there to give Josh Dobbs the edge. He could walk himself into the end zone.
Andre, a lot of times this time of year we talk about bowl games and teams who want it more. Yeah. Who wants to be here? Who has the wherewithal to play hard throughout the game? Nebraska was right there. They had him at a 3rd and 10, but couldn't bring down Kamara. Now all of a sudden Tennessee goes back up to touchdown. Mike Riley's team is a great fourth quarter team, but you got to be within striking distance to get there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. So when you come out of the locker room, the message will be, hey, one snap at a time. We need some positive things to happen. Let's stay away from penalties, things that where we're beating ourselves. Line up properly and stop giving up the edges when we're on defense, because they're so fast. Tennessee's so fast with Kamara, Dobbs, Kelly. Those guys, either one of them, they get the outside perimeter, and it's a track meet.
Short kick from Tennessee. And Nebraska have decent field position, but only 5 seconds left. By the way, that touchdown run for Josh Dobbs, his 11th of the season, he tied his own school single season record for rushing touchdowns by a quarterback that he shares with Heath Shuler, who finished 2nd in the Heisman voting back in the early 90s.
Heck of a player and a great career, Josh Dobbs. You talk about the course load that young man takes and still getting it done on Saturdays. Amazing.
Riker 5 takes a knee. His touchdown pass to Brandon Riley got Nebraska to within striking distance, but then a couple of big plays to close the half for Josh Dobbs in this Tennessee offense. The completion to Kamara covered 10 yards to keep the drive alive. And then Dobbs with his 2nd touchdown run of the game. Volunteers trying to finish this season on a high note. And what a difference it's been in halves. Last half at Vandy and now here this first one in Nashville. For more, Cole Kublik standing by with Butch Jones.
Coach Jones, how much easier is your job when Josh Dobbs is playing this way?
Well, he's made some plays for us, obviously, with his arm and his feet and some improvising on some plays as well, but he's a special player. I thought we left too many opportunities out there, scoring opportunities in the first half, and against a good football team like Nebraska, you can't do that.
Defensively, they crossed the 50 one time, but they do get the big play to put a touchdown up before the half. What adjustments do you need to make on that side of the football?
Well, again, it was a play action pass, and we had an MA in coverage, so we'll get that corrected. We just have to continue to rally the football. We're playing a good football team.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
308 yards of offense for Tennessee in the first half. They dominate time of possession and rack up 18 first downs. Volunteers with the lead 21-7 at the half. After the break, it'll be Reese Davis, Joey Galloway, and David Pollock on hand for the Buick Halftime Report. Nashville here in Music City. Tennessee with a 2-touchdown lead as we get ready to start the second half. Welcome back, everybody. Tom Hart alongside Heisman Trophy winner Andre Ware. Nebraska made a game of it with a big pass to Brandon Riley. I guess the question going into the second half, do the Huskers have enough offense to close the gap and take the lead in this thing?
I think so, but they're going to have to open it up or commit to opening it up and spreading Tennessee out where they can make some plays and move the football down the field. They're not going to beat Tennessee in the trenches, that's a given. But Josh Dobbs in the first half was unbelievable. You see him here, his first touchdown run, this one right before the half, pretty much untouched into the end zone. And here's the one over the top, Riker Fife to Riley, who made a heck of a catch An even better throw by the quarterback. They are going to have to commit to making some plays down the field.
Those drives came from Nebraska when they threw it on first down. Otherwise, they ran it on first down each of the first six possessions. Total yards for Tennessee, 308 yards, 19 plays in Nebraska territory. The Huskers ran only two in plus territory in the first half. Nebraska, when they got off to this great start, 7-0 on the season, they scored 24 points or more in all seven games. They failed to do so in their three Big Ten losses. Aaron Medley will kick it off to start the second half. By the way, Tennessee in their smoky gray uniforms is a tribute to the victims of the Gatlinburg fires and the fires throughout the Smoky Mountains in East Tennessee. Nebraska returning the favor by wearing a Gatlinburg Strong helmet decal. The second half underway from Music City, and it starts with a flag on Tennessee and a kickoff out of bounds. So we know what's coming there. Let's go down the field and check in with Cole Kublik, who talked with Nebraska head coach Mike Riley.
Tom, coach, talked to Coach Riley coming out of the half. He said, we must get more aggressive offensively. We're going to take some shots, try to push the ball downfield, maybe expect a few more first down passes. As far as an answer for Josh Dobbs, he said, four-man rush is not going to get it done. Too many run lanes for Josh Dobbs when we only bring four. Expect more pressure in the second half.
Kind of feel like you should have bought me a football for Christmas so we could all hold one on camera. Cole?
I got one here.
You do? You travel with one.
That's right.
They start off with a screen to the edge, and DeMorne Pearsonell is able to pick up three. Riker Fife is a unique quarterback. He's not afraid to change his arm angle, whether it's necessary or not. That one kind of sidearm out to the perimeter.
Well, the good ones can. I mean, you look at Aaron Rodgers, he can do it. Matthew Stafford the other night threw a dart sidearm. Brett Favre was kind of known for it as well, but the good ones can change the arm angle and still be accurate.
The way Cole had that prop because the kickoff that went out of bounds nearly hit him. Second and seven, Fife to throw again, and he finds Pearsonell. Loss of football. Tennessee pounces on it. Malik Foreman is there, and it's Tennessee football.
A heck of a job. Not sure who was able to stick their hand in there and rake it out. Watch at the end of this, it's actually Foreman. Not only does he recover the fumble, he's the one that caused it. Reaches in there, rakes it out. Indeed a fumble. And a Tennessee football. They had some things going, spreading the ball out, moving it around a little bit in the passing game, and Tennessee coming up with a turnover.
That is a devastating loss for Nebraska, a team that turns it over for the first time in the last 15 quarters. Volunteers closed on their final possession of the second half. Now they get great field position to start the second half. Dobbs steps up in the pocket, fires deep down the sideline. Jennings incomplete. Coverage by Joshua Kalu.
I love the thought, though. You have a big turnover, a sudden change, and then you go in attack mode on offense to push it down the field. You've got two dynamic playmakers on the outside in Jennings and Malone. Give them a chance to make a play.
Talking with Butch Jones this week and about the development of his wide receivers, he agreed that that's one of the biggest moves that this Tennessee program made in the last half of the season. Those guys going up and making plays. Jennings takes the direct snap, will take off the left side, spins his way inside the 40 for a gain of five. Kyron Williams to stop for Nebraska. Remember, they're without safety Antonio Reed, who was carted off midway through the second quarter.
Williams is a playmaker, led the team in interceptions. Excellent range player on the back end where he can cover a lot of ground back there. Good size for a safety too, as well. 6'1", 195 pounds.
Kamara in motion. Dobbs on third and five. Finds Kamara, and he's taken down behind the sticks. Gain of only three.
Got enough, though, to make Butch Jones think about going for it here. I mean, they had him stopped well short of the first down marker, and then all of a sudden he kept grinding and pulling defenders closer and closer, and put him in a situation for
Here's Jones to go for it here. Feel comfortable enough to go for it.
2 for 8 on fourth downs over the course of the season. Volunteers trying to cash in on their takeaway.
This is where they like Dobbs.
He'll give it to Kelly. Kelly stopped! Frieda Mackin-Molladoon was the first man there. The Volunteers turn it over on downs.
Ellen Mokendoon moved over from tight end a year ago and had a great start last season before a knee injury sidelined him for the second half of the year. But there, he has been kind of active all game long. Here makes the biggest play of the game for Nebraska defensively.
It may be unfair by using hindsight, but what do you think of Butch Jones's decision to go for
it? I still like it. I like it. I mean, maybe you go with a bigger physical, more agile Dobbs in that situation. They love him and running him in short yardage situations, but I still like the call.
Ozigbo will start the second half at tailback for Nebraska. Or pardon me, start this possession. And Ozigbo is able to fight his way for a 3-yard gain on first down. Kendall Vickers with the stop.
Ozigbo battled injuries late in the year himself. Nice change of pace back to Newby, and then Trey Bryan, who's nursing a hamstring in this one. A good young player, true freshman that came on as the season progressed.
Alonzo Moore just limped off the field for Nebraska. He's been battling an ankle injury. Fife has Ozigbo behind him, the big back for Nebraska. And he fires it to Carter, who's brought down immediately by Derek Barnett. No gain. Well, Divine Ozigbo's been a tailback the last few plays for Nebraska. For an update on that, let's check in with Cole.
Terrell Newby, 34, who was in the game a little bit earlier, Tom, we saw him. Some sort of an issue with his chest. He left the game a little bit earlier. Most likely not set to return, according to the Nebraska staff.
Well, that's big news for Nebraska. He's their leading rusher, all-conference Big Ten performer. They say Ozigbo is finally healthy after battling injuries the second half of the season. But a much different back. Now 3rd and 6 for the Huskers.
You see the pass set way back here.
Whoa! Tennessee way offsides. Rashawn Golden was 3 steps past the line of scrimmage.
What I'm trying to make is Nick Gates is giving Derek Barnett
offside.
A lot of respect.
Number 7, unabated to the quarterback. 5-yard penalty. Still 3rd down.
You know, we're talking to Butch Jones about Rashawn Golden yesterday, and he said he's one of our most consistent players, and one of those consistencies is that he'll have 2 busts a game.
Yep. You see here, look at this stance for Nick Gates. How far back he is, almost a yard and a half, almost 2 yards off the football, trying to get a head start so that he can get a pass set working against Barnett. But you're right, Golden, he'll make some great plays, and you just have to live with the mistakes and hope that the great plays outweigh the mistakes.
Luke McNitt is in at fullback for Nebraska, the junior from Kearney. 3rd and 1. Fife kept it in the first half. This time he hands it off. Ozigbo moves a pile and stretches
nice.
For a first down. Somehow he squirted through, and it's a gain of 3.
Nett the fullback as well, helping out, helping pave a way for Ozigbo. See here, nice push inside. Nobody getting penetration in the middle to stop him before the momentum gets itself started. Easy pickup to move the chains.
Well, that makes that flag and Golden loom even larger because it produced a 3rd and 1. Nebraska able to keep the drive alive. Just their 7th first down of the game. Fife wants to throw. And he's taken down in the backfield. 2nd sack of the game for Tennessee. This time it's Corey Vereen.
He has an excellent motor. You talk about a nice compliment to Barnett on the other side. Vereen is that player. Barnett sees so many double teams, chips a tight end, that he gets freed up. You see him slip down and still gets up to sack the quarterback.
Andre, I think that goes to Corey Vereen's motor. He slips and falls, gets up, finishes the play, still ends up with a sack.
2nd and 14 now for Nebraska. It only allowed 11 sacks all season. They've allowed two today. Fife quickly to the outside, incomplete behind Riley. Ball's ruled a forward pass and therefore dead. Third and 14.
Yeah, it's thrown out in front of Riley for being an incomplete pass. But you talk about getting up the field and even getting in throwing lanes. Now it's Vereen Barnett. Watch Barnett on this side. He's changed sides now. Up the field has an effect on the throw from Fife.
Third down, 14. Pressure from Barnett. Ball came loose. Still hasn't been whistled. Looked like a forward pass and an incompletion.
It is. It's actually a fumble, I think.
Cortez McDowell ends up recovering for Tennessee. It all came courtesy of Derek Barnett. It was ruled on the field an incomplete pass.
Really look, I didn't hear a whistle. Let it go. Sees the ball coming forward as he's trying to make the throw. Buzz down, take a look at this.
Ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. The previous play is under review.
Here's the deal. If it's ruled a fumble, that's fine. But there is no clear and immediate recovery of this fumble. Well, I guess it depends on your definition of immediate, but watch how the ball squirts free for a few moments, and numerous players had an opportunity.
Well, it looked as though some of the officials were allowing it to finish, where they, I don't think they heard a whistle either, and were playing it as though it were a fumble and waiting on someone to pick it up, and not sure who ends up recovering this at the end of it. Still don't see the football among bodies.
Pac-10 coordinator of officials Dale Newhouse has a headset on with us up in the booth. Dale, what did you see from that at the outset? Is that an incomplete forward pass or is that a fumble?
This call is going to be made by the referee as whether it's a pass or a fumble. And that's why everybody else waited, because they're waiting for him to make a decision on that.
Okay, what did you see on the replay now that you've seen it a couple of times? Did it look like his arm was coming forward? And specifically, let me ask you this. What is the replay crew looking at in this scenario?
They're looking to see if the hand comes forward without the ball, an empty hand. And in this case, he gets screened by number nine. And you can't tell whether that hand
is
empty or not.
The ruling on the field stands.
So you get, that's where we go. You couldn't tell.
Andre, now that you know exactly what they're looking for, I seem to see an empty hand come forward without the football. Looked incomplete.
I see it as well, and obviously there wasn't enough to confirm it, so they just went with what was called on the field. But
it's a missed opportunity in one way. If that would have been a fumble, it would have been a sack for Derek Barnett, and he would own the Tennessee career record for sacks. He's currently tied with Reggie White all time.
Yeah, I think Tennessee ended up recovering the ball.
Indeed. So after the punt, it'll be Tennessee football starting at the 22-yard line after that 34-yard punt. Missed opportunity for Nebraska. 9:12 to go in the third quarter. Ball back to the Volunteers in Nashville. Louisville on ABC. Two great matchups, both at 11 a.m. on ESPN and ABC. And a flashback to what Lamar Jackson did right here in Nashville in the Music City Bowl against Texas A&M last year. He was dynamic. It was a preview of what was to come during this Heisman season. He accounted for four touchdowns, 226 yards on the ground, 227 through the air.
Yeah, we were here, got a chance to see it, had a chance to peek behind the curtain. Boy, is he a special, special player.
Well, Joshua Dobbs, Tennessee's version of a dual threat quarterback, has put up good numbers today. And on first down, he's able to complete it to Juwan Jennings. Fifth catch for Jennings. That one goes for 7 yards.
A first down pass of their own. Tennessee breaking tendencies. Jennings, nice,
Nice start to this game for him. 5 catches, 53 yards, and 10 targets. Been
on 2nd and 3, John Kelly. And he's able to pick up the first down after Michael Rose Ivy tripped him up.
Well, he is a tough runner and a guy that just brings a little extra, a little attitude and energy to the practice field each and every day. It carries over into the games, and his teammates, they want to work for him. The offensive line, kind of a, he's a contagious player. The offensive line, they know when he's in the game, it's just a little bit of blocking will go a long way with John Kelly in the ball game.
Here's Kelly. Physical running style is able to pick up 5. Remember, this is a Tennessee program that lost their starting running back. Jalen Hurd refused to go in late in the South Carolina game, eventually left the team, told Butch Jones he had designs to transfer to become a wide receiver somewhere else.
Still scratching my head over that move.
We talked to Mike DeBoer, the offensive coordinator, about it yesterday, not specifically about Hurd, but how Kamara and Kelly almost seem to be better fits for this offense. And not to denigrate Hurd, but he said, listen, the secret there, as Dobbs takes off straight up the middle. And he gashes Nebraska for 29 yards before Kalu brings him down.
Just not used to seeing so many big plays given up by this Nebraska defense, but another block. Good block by Jason Kroon, the tight end, to free up Josh Dobbs.
Here's Kamara, and can't make it back to the line of scrimmage, back to the board. He said the strength of Kamara within this offense, as you've talked about throughout the game, is his versatility. We can empty the backfield, we can split him out. He's a great receiver, and thus far today, Kamara is their leading receiver with 6 catches. And some of those things just didn't fit what Jalen Hurd was as a running back.
I think Jalen Hurd is a downhill, you know, come at you type of back, and they just weren't using him that way, and I think frustration set in. Could have saved it for after the season, though.
Pressure to Dobbs, and he's able to get it out to Juwan Jennings. By the way, speaking of offensive coordinator Mike DeBoer, who was another offensive mind at Tennessee's practice when we went there this week, that was Mark Helfrich, the former Oregon head coach, who was let go after losing to Oregon State in the finale this season.
In town to watch Marcus Mariota, visit with him, and lo and behold, he breaks his leg. They plan to come in and watch the Titans-Texans game on Sunday.
Now, Helfrich has 3 years and $11.5 million still coming his way from Oregon. Dobbs uncorks one deep that is too much for Malone. So if, and he'll get paid that regardless, but if he wants to get back into coaching and right back on the horse, you think he would be an attractive candidate as an offensive coordinator or perhaps co-offensive coordinator on Rocky Top?
I think no doubt about it. All the weapons that are here, and a lot of talented players still in the program. Even if, you know, guys like Josh Malone were to declare, you still have Jennings and a bunch of others that are still here for Mark Helfrich to coach up.
Including some good quarterbacks, Quentin Dorman, sophomore quarterback, Jared Guarantano. He's redshirting this year. 46-yard attempt here for Aaron Medley, whose career long is 47. And that one is good. So Tennessee able to add to its advantage. Aaron Medley with his 11th field goal of the season for the junior from Lewisburg, Tennessee. Everything looking orange today in Nashville. All Tennessee. The most recent of 5 national championships for Nebraska came against Tennessee in the Orange Bowl to close the 97 season. Amon Green at 201 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Tom Osborne won a national title in his last game at Nebraska. It was also Peyton Manning's last game at Tennessee. Scott Frost, by the way, had 3 touchdown runs in that game. Nebraska has met Tennessee in the postseason twice. They've won both games. And I grew up a big Scott Frost fan. Riker Fife from Grand Island, Nebraska, has his work cut out for him. If the Huskers want to find some offense, can find some offense and come back in this one.
Thought they were moving the ball well to start this half, but then the fumble. Tennessee the ball, and they were able to capitalize.
no chance for a return for Nebraska. So here's what Nebraska is missing today. Besides quarterback Tommy Armstrong Jr., Jordan Westerkamp out with a knee injury, all-conference performer, second only to the great Johnny Rogers, 36 consecutive games with a reception, fourth in school history in receiving yards. He had knee surgery earlier this month and is working on his rehab to get ready for a professional career. And Tommy Armstrong Jr., one of the best quarterbacks statistically in Nebraska history, had a scary injury against Ohio State, then a hamstring injury against Minnesota, showed great guts to come back and play in the finale against Iowa. He met with the media this week after practice and talked about his pro aspirations, saying he'd be willing to move from quarterback, running back, or wide receiver to realize that dream. DeMornay Pearson-Ell with a big gain of 18 yards for Nebraska. It's just a shame, whether you're a Nebraska fan or not, that we don't get a chance to see Tommy Armstrong or Jordan Westerkamp in this game. So it's up to guys like Pearson-Ell, to be game changers.
Yeah, I think Stanley Morgan needs to get involved in this game at some point as well. But you've got to take advantage of it, looking for Stephen Carter as well to help out.
Stanley Morgan Jr. does not have a catch today. Back to Ozigbo, breaks through. Divine Ozigbo in a foot race. And he bowls over Golden for another couple more. 42-yard rumble for Divine Ozigbo.
This is just kind of inflicting your will on a defense. We're going to stay committed to running the football. And I mean, this is coming right at him. Nice blocks inside. Dylan Utter, the center, with a nice seal block. Tanner Farmer as well. And that opened up things for the running back Ozigbo.
First Nebraska run of over 10 yards in this game. Mikael Wilbon is now in the game at tailback, two back set with Ozigbo. And the first touch for Wilbon, sophomore from Chicago, and he's brought down by Jonathan Kongbo.
He is going to be a good player. Of a tweener type that can play defensive end in a 4-3 and slide out in a 3-4, can play on the end. It'll be a big body as well. He'll add some weight in the offseason.
Riker Fife has thrown one touchdown today. That's a lone score for Nebraska. Pressure, slings it complete. And inside the 10 is Stanley Morgan Jr.
Nice. However you can get it out of there, and if you can get some accuracy on it. We talked about him getting himself involved, Stanley Morgan Jr., but watch this one from the hip right there. Getting some pressure just right from the hip. Just a quick flick of the football. That's good work.
First catch for Morgan. Third and a very important five for Nebraska. Pressure from the edge from Golden. Into the corner of the end zone. Cut! It's Brandon Riley again. Touchdown, Nebraska!
Just a smash route combination here where the outside receiver is coming inside. The slot receiver, Riley, goes to the corner. And I tell you what, Riker Fife put it up early with a little bit of air under it and allowed Brandon Riley to run under it. Well, this is a well-thrown football to the corner. Nice job of getting 1 foot down inbounds.
So one former walk-on to another in a program that made its name with walk-ons back under Bob Devaney and Tom Osborne. Riley did not have a touchdown catch all season. The Lincoln native has two tonight. What a feeling.
Think bowls aren't important? I'm asking Brandon Riley that.
3:26 to go in the third quarter. Nebraska has been a second half and specifically a fourth quarter team all season, and they are back to within striking distance. For the second time, a pair of Nebraskans, Riker Fife and Brandon Riley, hook up for a Cornhusker score. and the Huskers back in this one in Nashville. And a pretty good week to be here in Nashville, great sports town. A few Blackhawks fans in the area last night playing the Predators. Blackhawks came away with a 3-2 win, and we've seen all sorts of college gear around town the last couple of days, haven't we?
Yeah, it's been nice.
Cameron Sutton decides to bring this one out. He bends it to the 20-yard line and taken out at the 24. Aggressive play for Cameron Sutton. Let's take you back to that Nebraska touchdown.
Yeah, it's an easy read. You get Stanley Morgan on the outside, and this is man-to-man. He's going to run the route inside, and that allows Brandon Riley to go to the corner. It's a simple read for the quarterback. Smash route concept, easy read. All of a sudden, Riley comes open. Nice job of putting some air under it right to the back pylon. At Houston, that was 67 even for me. Still remember it to this day.
Riker Fife will remember that one. His second touchdown pass of the game. Not as efficient as he was in his previous start this season against Maryland, but facing a much different opponent. Josh Dobbs and Tennessee answer Nebraska's first score with a drive and score of their own. And here on first down, they throw it for 7.
Yeah, defensively, they're going to need a stop here. Can't allow Tennessee to just continue to chew up the clock, positive yards, moving the chains, and then kind of methodically going about their business to shorten this football game.
Juwan Jennings will take his third snap of the game at the quarterback position. He hands it off this time to Kamara. He's got a first down. He was on skates and he got popped by Kyron Williams.
Boy, just the speed of Kamara and Kelly, both backs can really get the edge.
Tom, Kamara is listed as the number 4 NFL running back by multiple scouts. He's got the speed, he's got the durability. I think he's going to make a great NFL back.
Started his college career playing for Nick Saban at Alabama. Dobbs on play action, steps up, fires deep, a beautiful pass, and it is off the hands of Juwan Jennings. It was placed perfectly. Kalu had the coverage.
Yeah, Kalu slipped down. Jennings was going to waltz into the end zone with this one. Going to watch here. We'll see, and a little out and up, a double move. Kalu starts to slip. That should have been 6. I mean, you can't throw a better ball. You get about 3 of those in a game, and you're just hoping to hit 2 out of 3.
He's only caught 6 of the 12 thrown his way today. A couple of those misfires. Nebraska brings pressure on 2nd and 10, able to swing it out to the tight end, Ethan Wolf. And Wolf is able to pick up a first down.
Well, that's showing you that the senior leadership of Josh Dobbs. Played a lot of football, recognizes the blitz. He goes right in the face of the blitz where the defender is leaving a vacated area. That's where Ethan Wolf is hanging out to convert the first down.
Here's Kelly. Gain of 3.
Boy, he just runs angry, doesn't he? Every time he touches it, it's just an anger run.
We had Tennessee late in the season before the Kentucky game. I had a chance to meet John Kelly, and his coaching staff and his players rave about this kid, and it's simply because he's real. And I think that's what teammates appreciate about great teammates. Yeah. That's why they love Derek Barnett, because he gets the most out of him. Dobbs almost split in half, but he gets it to Kroom, and Kroom stays on his feet. It's a 30-yard rumble before Akinmolaudun finally brings him down, and a Tennessee first down inside the 10.
Well, poor tackling has been the Achilles heel of Nebraska today. You see it right here. 3 defenders have a chance to bring down Kroom, neither of which wrap up, and that allowed for the yards after the catch.
Tennessee wants to go with some tempo here. Out of the shotgun, Dobbs hands it off. And Kelly met for no gain. First time Josh Dobbs has really been hit hard in a dropback tonight.
Kind of fumbled, mishandled the snap, but still able to just make a play of it. Just got enough of a grip on the football to shoot it out to Kroom, and boy, did he do the right thing with it.
It was Michael Rose Ivy, the senior out of Kansas City Rockhurst High School, who brought the pressure. He's going to bring it into the third quarter. When we return for the fourth quarter here in Music City, Tennessee, we'll be looking at a second and goal. Josh Dobbs trying to hold on to this Tennessee lead. In his way, a Nebraska team that has seen magical fourth quarters all season long. Number 21, Tennessee leads Nebraska 24-14 through three. Welcome back to the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. As part of Capital One Bowl Mania, across the river from downtown Nashville, Big Ten SEC battle, and Tennessee knocking on the door, but with a 10-point lead as we start the fourth quarter. Huskers have been a resilient team all season long. Mike Riley attributes part of that to the issues they had to deal with in the offseason with the death of their punter, Sam Fultz. He said, we're just a tough-minded team. And in the fourth quarter, they've been better than their opponent just about every time out. Their offense has been good. Their defense has been great. They need a big defensive stand here as Tennessee looks at a second and goal.
Well, they need one of those 18 turnovers that they forced this year. 16 interceptions, two fumble recoveries. They need either one or in either way right now. Yeah, Josh Malone over here in the slot, wide open.
They'll put Kalu on him. John Kelly is a Tennessee running back. Dobbs wants to change it up. Play clock is at 6. Here's Kelly. Oh, he almost broke it, but he's taken down by his ankle inside the 5 by Michael Rose Ivy. Cole, what do you see down there?
75 left guard, Deshaun Robertson. Tom, I thought he was one of the best guards in the SEC coming into the season. I'm right down here across the end zone. I love the leverage that this young man plays with. Great feet, great body balance. He's going to come back for his senior year next year. I think he could be at the top of the list as far as the guard position in the SEC and NFL draft prospects.
Well, this is a big third down for Tennessee. See if they run behind Robertson here. Dobbs to throw, pulls it back, pressured, will escape, and Josh Dobbs is going to score for the third time tonight.
Well, just there to make a play defensively and can't find a way to get him on the ground. When the pocket collapses, reaching, you see it here, he's closed in. You got to make that play. Easier said than done when it's Josh Dobbs.
Third rushing touchdown of the night for Dobbs. That drive highlighted by a 30-yard completion to Jason Kroom. And Dobbs now owns a school record outright for rushing touchdowns in a single season by a Tennessee quarterback. That was a 9-play, 76-yard drive that ate up 4 minutes and 17 seconds. What a way to cap the career. The senior quarterback Josh Dobbs, 3 times he's carried it himself to pay dirt, and the Vols have opened up a lead on Nebraska here in the fourth quarter. Just one time.
Oh, I'm walking on. The playoff is here.
Touchdown, Huskies!
Alabama's been absolutely unstoppable.
Then.
Clemson's offense is on another level.
The college football playoff semifinals tomorrow on ESPN.
Well, we've seen it all season from Joshua Dobbs. Really have seen it throughout his career as a Tennessee quarterback. seems to be the kind of guy that always makes the right decision.
Yeah, you talked about it and describing him. A dual threat quarterback. That's the first of three touchdown runs and made it look easy on the last two here. Just stepping up in the pocket, saw some green grass and kind of waltzes into the end zone. Nice job both throwing and running today. 232 yards through the air and another 102 on the ground with three touchdown runs. Amazing bowl game for Josh Dobbs.
Dobbs' worst performance this season came in Tennessee's loss at South Carolina. What was unknown to Butch Jones at the time and what we were just recently told about is that that week the aerospace engineering major had a major project due. He was up in the Tennessee library until 2 a.m. multiple times that week and still really hasn't forgiven himself for a poor performance in the loss against South Carolina. But he's all over the Tennessee record book, and he's just shy of Peyton Manning's single season record for total yards.
And when you Google student athlete, there should be a picture of Josh Dobbs right there.
Interned at Pratt and Whitney over consecutive summers. And after the Gatlinburg wildfires, Butch Jones and the Tennessee team eventually made it to the mountains and visited with Tennessee fans in an effort to bring some relief to the victims of those fires. It was unbeknownst to them until he had arrived that Josh Dobbs did the same thing the day after. He went up on his own and was in the shelter visiting with several of the victims and their families. Pearson L with the reception takes it for 11 yards. And it's all of that kind of rolled into one that makes Josh Dobbs one of the most beloved players in Tennessee history. Yeah. They have a great Mount Rushmore of College Football Hall of Famers. But guys like Dobbs, Eric Berry, going back to Peyton, of course.
Reggie White.
Even Johnny Majors, who was a great wing back before he took over as the head coach. It's much more for Tennessee fans and Vol Nation. It's yeah, they want to win, but it's about more than that. I think Nebraska fans can relate. Fife going deep. Oh, my goodness. He did it again. Brandon Riley hauls one in for another big gain. It goes for 39.
You talk about it. This is big play, Brandon Riley. That same sideline earlier in the game made a heck of a grab for a touchdown in the end zone, but climbing the ladder right here. Tremendous concentration, and about Fife just giving his man number 87 a chance to make a play.
Brandon Riley was a child prodigy as a hockey player. He began skating at age 3. He eventually gave up the sport to concentrate on football because he said he just had too much fun hanging out with his friends on the football field. His older brother was a great hockey player as well and had to move away from Lincoln and spend years away from the family to go to other locales to play hockey year-round. Riley said, you know what, that's not the life for me. I want to just be out there with my guys playing football. And what a way to end his Nebraska career.
He's usually one of the outside receivers. Had to move inside at slot because of the injury to Jordan Westerkamp. Every once in a while, they slip him back outside. And boy, has he made some plays.
More in motion. Fife looking left. Barnett nearly got him. Fife directing traffic, throws on his back foot, and it's incomplete. Barnett still a sack away from the all-time Tennessee career record, and he had Fife within his grasp.
I think he's cramping up a little bit, but he had it right there. I mean, the opportunity to come up with a sack is there still. Kind of owning Nick Gates in this game. Not Fife. Fife has got more movement than you give him credit for. People say, oh, he's just a pocket passer. Saw him break a nice big run against Maryland in that game that he started. Avoiding sacks in this one on a couple of occasions.
Third down, 8. Kendall Vickers a little fired up for Tennessee.
Yeah, Dylan Utter got a shot on him and he couldn't retaliate. The official stepped in between them.
Delay a game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So third and 13 now.
Tell you, showing some respect to Barnett. Look how deep left tackle Nick Gates is to get a head start.
Fife dancing around Barnett from behind, and it falls incomplete. Barnett ended up taking five down after he got rid of the football. He was back there with Pongo. It's a good 25 yards behind the line of scrimmage. And Drew Brown will come in to attempt a long field goal. Cole?
Tom, one thing I've noticed about Derek Barnett late in the season, he's added an inside move. We've talked about that dip and rip and how fast he gets to the edge on the outside of an offensive tackle, but become very effective as an inside rusher. And Andre mentioned the depth of the tackle. You begin to go deep quickly, Derek Barnett's going to burn you inside.
45-yard attempt, and it splits the uprights for Drew Brown, the junior from Southlake, Texas. Nebraska has two touchdowns and a field goal here. 12th make of the season for Brown. Family tradition continues in Nebraska.
Start from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back. Every purchase, everywhere.
It's a pregame flyover from the F-16s at the 187th Fighter Wing. Alabama Air National Guard.
That's pretty cool.
That's really cool. You see, he was inverted. <laughs> 31-17. You'd be home in about 8 minutes if you had a ride on one of those.
I don't know.
Another opportunity for a return, and out past the 30. Bird lost a football, scooped up by the Huskers. There's still life for this Nebraska squad. Recovered by Muhammad Barry. Just when you thought Tennessee could milk it.
Yeah, and exactly what they needed. Helmet's going to go right on the football. It's like JoJo Duman. Right there, helmet right on the ball, and it pops out.
It's the best turnover margin in the country. Hadn't seen much of it tonight for Nebraska, but a timely takeaway there. Doman popped it out. Barry recovered it. And in the fourth quarter, especially, Nebraska's plus 11. No one better in the country. It's part of their fourth quarter magic. Fife looking to throw out of the backfield. Ozipo makes the first man miss. He's got a first down, a gain of 12.
An excellent job by Stephen Carter, the tight end. He's in the route, but recognizes that Ozipo has the football and turns to throw a nice block. Watch this after the catch. It's number 11. He recognizes, spins right around, and just continues to play. That allows Ozipo to pick up the first down and move the chains.
Fife fires in zone off the hands of Brandon Riley. Talked with Riker Fife after Nebraska's practice a couple days ago. I said, it's really too bad you don't have Westerkamp. I know he's a great security blanket for you.
Yes.
He goes, yeah, but I got Riles, and I know Riley can get open, and he's gone to him time and again. But Riley took a tough shot, a helmet to the ribs, courtesy of Todd Kelly.
Yeah, ribs are right on the hip, right in that area. And Todd Kelly with a nice play separating Riley from the football.
Riley left the game in the first quarter after he banged his head on the turf. He's got two touchdown catches tonight. Ozigbo on second and 10. Well, the big fella can juke a little bit, can he? This will be close to a first down, maybe a football short, and it's going to set up third down for the Huskers.
He's got some great movement for a 230-pound back. Just a sophomore, got a very bright future here at Nebraska.
Cole, what do you see?
Brandon Riley, obviously a huge game, Tom. He stepped back to the back of the huddle. The trainers are taking a look at his lower extremity on the right side. Not really sure exactly what it is, but he's shaking up. Came limping off after he made the effort in the corner of the end zone.
Third and one. Fife keeps it. That's his second quarterback sneak conversion tonight. And it'll be first and goal inside the 10 for Nebraska.
Smart call. Mess around with too much ball handling. Just pick up the first down and you get yourself a fresh set of downs to continue this drive and try to get yourself back in this ball game.
And look who's back for Nebraska. Brandon Riley back in the huddle for the Huskers.
Where I'd be going with the football, that's for sure. Sure-handed kid with that runs great routes. Right there, number 87. Doesn't have to run far. They're on about the 8.
Miscommunication. Tennessee's linebackers, including Colton Jumper, late to get set on first and goal. Fife keeps it. He's in. Rushing touchdown for the former walk-on.
Once again, Seathan Carter, the tight end number 11, with a block that sends Fife into the end zone, and we got a ball game.
That is the first rushing touchdown of Riker Fife's season.
Watch the seal block there by number 11, Seathan Carter. That opens it up for Fife. Came all the way across the formation and a block in space.
The point after is good. A five-play, 31-yard scoring drive. It started with a Tennessee mistake. And Nebraska's fourth quarter magic seems to be alive and well. It started with a volunteer gift. The Husker takeaway set him up in great field position. And after Fife kept it to convert the first down, then he did it again to take it to the end zone.
To rack up yards, Dalvin Cook. An amazing season for that young man.
90 minutes away from kick there. 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter here. Cameron Sutton. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. You got to feel the momentum is on Nebraska's side right now, but Tennessee counters with one of the most successful quarterbacks in their school history. Josh Dobbs is not the kind of player that gets rattled.
No, and every time that Nebraska has scored, Josh Dobbs has driven his team down and responded. Nebraska, they got to have a stop here to get themselves. They're back in this ball game, but they have got to stop Josh Dobbs and Tennessee and force a punt, or maybe even another turnover to be a little bit better for the Huskers.
His three rushing touchdowns are a Music City Bowl record. Alvin Kamara takes it from him. Rose Ivy pinned on the edge, and Kamara turns in a 7-yard gain.
Well, Ethan Wolf did the pinning, and did he do it in an ugly way. What a block by Ethan Wolf.
Tennessee has been wildly successful on first down throughout this entire game. On second and 3. Out to Wolf, off of his hands.
Yeah, try to reward him for that block that he threw on the previous play. But it's just mind-boggling to me that Tennessee has continued to make plays on the edge. I mean, at some point, you just got to get wide and not allow plays to get outside of the defensive end where the linebackers aren't making plays and you're giving up leverage. I've said it several times tonight, but it continues to happen.
Third down, 3. Dobbs to take off. He's got the first down again, and he's got it past the 40. Kalu finally brings him down, and just when you think you have a shot, the guy who's 6'3", 210 finds a way to slither past.
I'm sure they faced an athlete at quarterback the caliber of Josh Dobbs all season long. I mean, he's there and then he's not. This leaves you reaching and you're just grabbing air.
Two first downs and a touchdown on his three third down carries tonight. On play action, he wants it all. He's got Malone, who has steps. He's got it. Touchdown Tennessee, 59 yard strike. It's Dobbs to Malone.
I'd be watching this young man's last game as a Volunteer. But he gets behind Kalu, and they knew that Kalu was a little banged up from earlier in the game. They find the one-on-one matchup and take advantage of it. Whenever he decides to go to the next level, Tom, Josh Malone's going to be a good player for a long time for some football team.
You mentioned it. There's an answer. Every time Nebraska has scored, Tennessee has answered, and it's come from Josh Dobbs. First, he runs for the first down on third, and then he decides, you know what, I'm going to go up top to my guy, and Malone got separation.
Man, I mean, it's just they leave the middle of the field open. Kalu struggling to stay with him. He has got tremendous speed, the hands, the route running. He has it all. Size. At 6'3", over 200 pounds. Love the kid as a player.
He's been targeted six times tonight. He's got five for a buck 20 in that touchdown, his 11th on the season.
Tom, I thought it was intriguing. You asked Butch Jones and Mike DeBoer. What was in Josh Dobbs the second half of the season, and they both said, accuracy on the deep ball. He's been making those deep shots count for this Tennessee offense. Saw one payoff there.
And it's twofold. That was their goal for Dobbs in the offseason, and it paid off in the back half of the season in many ways because his receivers finally started to make plays. He's not a perfect quarterback, right, but he wasn't getting a heck of a lot of help from a receiving corps that was underperforming.
They started to step up, and any good quarterback performance is going to be made by the players around him, and they started to make plays.
Nelson lost the football. It looked like a white jersey was there for the recovery, and indeed Nebraska has it. Cost them a few yards of field position. Capital One Bowl Mania continues tomorrow. Bright and early at 11 a.m. on ESPN and ABC. The Tax Slayer Bowl between Georgia Tech and Kentucky will air on ESPN, and the Buffalo Wild Wings Citrus Bowl between number 20 LSU and number 13 Louisville will be on ABC. Two great matchups, both at 11 a.m. on ESPN and ABC.
Still more than enough time for Riker Fife to get his team back in this game. Take a look here where ball's clearly out. And Nebraska recovery, but yeah, there's still plenty of time in this game.
Christian Bailey, right place, right time for the recovery. Fife wanted the slant, got pressured by Barnett, and he will dump it off incomplete, trying to get it to Morgan.
Barnett has been so close on a lot of occasions.
What do you think of this move, Cole?
That's the inside move that I was referring to earlier, Tom. He's been so dominant with the outside rush, speed rush and dip and rip. He's been owning offensive tackles with that inside move in the second half of the season.
Nick Gates is healthier than he's been most of the season, but he told reporters this week he's still only about 90%. Nobody wants to face Derek Barnett at less than optimal. Golden coming on. The blitz ball was loose, and Fife seemingly fell on it.
It's that deep set, or his stance at the line of scrimmage. He's so deep that you start up the field, it gets him on his heels. And you see here, this is Barnett when the ball's on the ground, getting in on that action. But Gates is so deep. You see Fife watching Barnett as well, but he's so deep that you start outside. The over and under comes into play, and it's easy to get there. Here he is again, lined up over Gates.
All eyes are on Derek Barnett.
And you see how far back the stance is there. That's a great, great look at it.
He comes unabated. They set up the screen, and it's incomplete. Trying to get it to Pearsonell.
Oh, what a player.
Nick Gates was asked about Barnett this week. He said he's got the speed of Shalit Calhoun, the power of Randy Gregory. He says he reminds me more of Randy Gregory. He's now with the Cowboys and healthy, former Husker. Punting situation.
He just loves the game, loves the game.
Beautiful punt. Sutton started to hang a U-turn, is able to get upfield and taken down at the 38-yard line. We talked a lot about Derek Barnett today, and I think Nebraska fans could probably relate to this. One of his teammates was asked about him this week, and he said, Derek Barnett's not everybody's best friend, but what he does is he holds teammates accountable. He forces you to leave your comfort zone and become better. There's a great quarterback in Nebraska history that shared that trait. Tommy Frazier wasn't everybody's best friend, but he seemed to make people better. He helped lead them to a national title.
You don't have to be. You're just trying to get the best out of everybody. You know, cut the jokes on the way to the game, things of that sort. We have a mission. We're on a mission. We're going to play a football game. It's not joke time. Or if you don't want to be here, hey, there's the door. That's Derek Barnett and how he leads. Once he says something, doesn't say very much, but when he does, his teammates listen.
We all talked to him after Tennessee's practice yesterday. He said, listen, I just lead by example. I learned from my mom, you work hard, you do what you can, and others then will follow. And it seems very, very simple. No gain for Kelly on first down.
I told you last night, I shared that story with you last night. I was that guy in high school. But you know what? You don't care who likes you. We're trying to win. Well, you're making games. You're cracking jokes on the way to the game. Everybody's giggles and laughs. It's not the time to be messing around, horsing around. We're trying to go win football games. You only get a few in a year, and you work all year long for that.
It's a simple question. Is it important to you?
That's the question. How important is it to you?
Loss of four that time. That'll bring up third down.
And I can guarantee you, Derek Barnett, he doesn't care who likes him as long as you go win football games. You win games, hey. We can talk about it and share in it later, but not before.
Josh Dobbs has been magnificent on third down tonight. This a bit longer than his previous attempts. Third and 14. He is just shy of Peyton Manning's school record for total yards in a single season. Manning set it in his final year on Rocky Top, a year that ended with a loss to Nebraska in the Orange Bowl. Four-man rush on third and 14. Dobbs looking deep down the sideline. Malone too much. Would have been the record, and now Tennessee will punt it away. Nebraska down two scores with 6 minutes to go.
Still enough time. 6 minutes, three timeouts in your back pocket. Get a quick score here, and it's anybody's ball game.
Second year for Mike Riley as a head coach at Nebraska.
But you know what? We don't know where number nine is located. Yes. He's starting to have an effect on this game.
Short kick. Pearsonell, a flag down, takes a fair catch at the 27-yard line. 38-yard punt from Trevor Daniel. Injured Tennessee player as well. That's Mosley. Defensive back. They're looking at his left knee.
During the kick, holding number one receiving team. That 10-yard penalty will be enforced at the end of the kick. First down.
5:52 remaining in the fourth quarter. Nebraska down two touchdowns. They'll have the ball when we return.
Discover the toe-tapping excitement of the Music City for yourself. The authentic Nashville experience awaits you at Gaylord Opryland Resort. from our extraordinary...
They can just make plays. Excellent pass rusher. Variety of different moves to get to the quarterback. See him here just around. Just such a speed rusher. He could do it from the right side, the left side. And then this last one out in coverage shows you the versatility of Derek Barnett. Dropping from defensive end out in coverage and then making a play in space.
He tied the Tennessee sack record in the season finale against Vandy in the final play of the first half. The one concern for Tennessee coming into this one is if he were to get it, they might get a celebration penalty because all of his teammates want so badly for him to get that sack. They brought help on him that time. Riker Fife trying to go deep to Riley, and he overthrew. He's turned into his favorite receiver tonight.
I think now it's time for something deep and then like a deep comeback, deep curl. As you have Tennessee thinking that Riley's going to go deep, and he's been successful doing it. Now you get him overplaying down the field and just hook up.
Question is if Riker Fife would have time with
great
number
question.
Nine. They flop sides with Vereen a number of times. They do it again here. Second and 10. And movement. Nick Gates was backpedaling before the snap.
False start. Number 68 offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Gates is going to be a good football player. He is just overmatched tonight. And I think now it's starting to play between his helmet.
They chip Barnett. Fife on the run. Complete for a Nebraska first down to Stanley Morgan. They pick up 17.
He has got excellent arm strength and the accuracy is there. He's got good size. Watch him work here. He feels the pressure, just kind of slides. Eyes are still down the field and he's very accurate with the throw to Morgan.
Morgan didn't have a catch in the first half. He's got a couple of first down catches here late in this game. Too strong trying to find Ozigbo out of the backfield.
He was trying to lead him with a football so he could catch and run and just be a step or two in front of him.
Is that on the quarterback or the running back?
It's on the quarterback. He'll just throw one right out in front, a little bit lower, and maybe he makes a play on it.
On the same page with Alonzo Moore.
That time, Ozigbo and Gates got the better part of Barnett. He was chipping, and Ozigbo just kind of caught him helping out Gates. Watch this one. Tell you what, that's good work. And Gates going in for, he remembers the wrestling for them, yeah, from the other night. They're going in for the pin. 1, 2, 3.
He hadn't had many opportunities to do that tonight. Third down, 10. Here comes Golden. Barnett around the edge, hits Fife, and forces an incompletion. Wow.
Comes right back. All they did was make him mad. Will give you everything he has. Nice swim move just underneath.
Nebraska's been great on fourth downs this season. They'll leave the offense on the field facing a fourth and 10. Cole?
I like the fact that Bob Shoup brought a blitz to that side. Corner crash. That way the back that was helping out with Derek Barnett for a potential double team was taken out of the equation. You saw the effect the one-on-one that Barnett had.
Play clock at 3. They don't get it off.
Timeout, Nebraska. They're first. It's a 30-second timeout.
You know, I wonder if this scenario, you would be better off just taking the penalty. I mean, what's the biggest difference between 4th and 10 and 4th and 15 when you're going to need timeouts down two scores?
Well, a little easier to convert on 4th and 10 than 4th and 15, no doubt about it. But I mean, you can catch and run for the 10, because something underneath and maybe get the 10. 15 is stretching it, and you give the defense a little more, a few more calls to come up and stop.
Following the game, tune into ESPN3 for the postgame trophy ceremony presented by Capital One. So Nebraska down to two timeouts at 5:05 to go. One of the best in the country on fourth down conversions. Without Jordan Westerkamp in this game, their leading receiver, who was remarkable on third and fourth down scenarios all season. The man of the night, still without a sack.
Boy, he's been so close on so many plays.
He goes inside, Fife goes deep. Riley, incomplete. Flag on the play. Malone and Abernathy converge on Brandon Riley, and this will give Nebraska a first down. Excuse me, Markwell Osborne.
Pass interference, number 3 defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. That's an automatic first down.
Osborne, the true freshman, out there a little bit early on Riley. That's a tall order for the freshman. Abernathy trying to come over the top and help him out, but the game that Brandon Riley's having, I don't know that I'm putting a true freshman on him.
Fife backpedals, able to complete it to Morgan, and Morgan stumbles his way forward for a few extra, a pickup of 6.
Boy, that really is attractive, the way he can change arm angles and still make accurate throws. Somebody watching this game is going to be impressed with Riker Fife on the next level. Might just get a free agent tryout, who knows.
On second down, over the middle, complete. First catch of the game for Reimers, and he gets taken down after a Nebraska first down. It goes for 24.
Nice job here, standing tall in the pocket and out in front.
Fife to the slant, incomplete. Galdon had the coverage at time on Gabe Rawn. So Fife has gone to Rawn and Reimers for the first time in this game on this drive on back-to-back plays.
That was so close. With Galdon with the left hand propelling himself around.
It's been all through the air for Nebraska on this drive, playing with fire with Derek Barnett opposite Nick Gates. Fife running for his life. Congo swatted him up, but somehow he got rid of it.
Maybe
Tennessee
grounded.
Saying, why not grounding? The nearest player was an offensive lineman, Gerald Foster, and there comes the flag. This will be a penalty and loss of down.
Intentional grounding. Number 17, offense. That's a loss of down at the spot of the foul. Third down.
It's a sack for Jonathan Kongbo.
Yeah, there's been so much attention paid to Barnett that they're forgetting the other guys, Kongbo and Vickers and Vereen on the other side. They're coming free as well.
Kongbo almost took Fife's helmet off with the left hand. It's a loss of 16.
He is going to be a good football player. Mentioned the measurables of Kongbo. Versatile player that can play up and down the defensive line now.
Barnett has switched the other side. He gets it! Derek Barnett has set a Tennessee career record for sacks. Back-to-back sacks for the Vols.
What a player.
Numerous Tennessee offensive players came on the field to celebrate with Barnett.
Yeah, Butch Jones does the smart thing and calls the timeout to allow the entire football team to take part in the celebration. He has worked his tail off tonight to get this sack.
And let's point one thing out here. If you're a Nebraska fan, you might look at this as being unsportsmanlike, but it is more a reflection of the love that Tennessee's players have and the respect they have for Derek Barnett.
And he's still on the field playing. There he is working against Conrad, the right tackle this time, and able to get home, finally get home.
But you're talking about a sack record
that was held by Reggie White. That's a little special. I don't care what school you call home.
Zach Darlington has entered the game for Nebraska at quarterback. Riker Fife is off the field. This will be Darlington's first snap as a college quarterback. He is normally their holder and a former wide receiver, a high school standout at quarterback, and his first ever pass is incomplete on 4th and 35. Nebraska turns it over on downs. Back to Derek Barnett, who has set a new Tennessee career record for sacks, better than the Minister of Defense, 33 in three seasons for the Nashville native.
How long did that record stand? A long time.
Early 80s for Reggie White on Rocky Top. So the ball back to Tennessee with 3:25 left here in Nashville. And a reminder, when we're done here, we'll get you to South Florida, the Capital One Orange Bowl coming up next. Jabril Peppers, Michigan standout, getting loose and ready for that one. That's coming up at 8 o'clock Eastern, Michigan and Florida State. Gain of one on first down. So two-score lead for Tennessee. Derek Barnett gets the record. It's a Tennessee season, at times, was just, to be brutally honest, was a hot mess. The loss at South Carolina, the loss to close the season at Vanderbilt, and Butch Jones laughed yesterday. He said, listen, people say I'm on the hot seat. We haven't had a guy drafted in 2 years. We had 18 different injuries. Yeah. But what he's disguising with that is that the expectations are so great on Rocky Top that when you get better every year, fans expect that to continue. They were picked to win the East. They were a top 10 team to open the season. And besides all that, what they're going to get out of this game is a great performance from Josh Dobbs, a great cap to the career for Barnett as well, and they're going to be able to end the season on a high note.
Yeah, and I think what fans have to realize is that that's not a reflection of Butch Jones of not having a player, because that's how a lot of programs are measured, of how many players you have or send to the NFL. You know, those two years aren't a reflection of him. That's before Butch Jones. He's coaching up. Those are players that should be coached up that were here before he got here. So he's done a fabulous job of recruiting. I think that string's going to break itself with guys like Derek Barnett, or if Josh Malone decides to declare for the draft, or Alvin Kamara for that matter.
They got the number one recruit in the nation and left tackle Trey Smith out of the Memphis area, so that tradition continues. Meanwhile, on the other side for Nebraska, they got to replace Tommy Armstrong. They'll have a new quarterback next year. Their offense should look
time
a
out,
lot
Nebraska.
Different.
They're second.
It's they tried second. With Tommy Armstrong in 2 years under Mike Riley to either convert him to a passer or to take advantage of his dual threat ability, and they had a hard time doing that last year, and now they'll turn it over to a passer next year. Meanwhile, back to Tennessee, another great class coming in, number 11 in the country, five ESPN 300 recruits out of the 26, including Trey Smith, the offensive tackle we're talking about.
Yeah, there'll be a few that will enroll in January and get to campus and be ready to go.
Butch called it the mid-season, the top mid-season recruiting class in the country. But we talk about Nebraska and what's next for them. They're right. Going to be more of a West Coast offense under Riley than they have been the first 2 years because they're going to have a passing quarterback. How might that look in Lincoln?
I think it'll look similar to what you saw tonight with Riker Fife. And still a lot of window dressing and a lot of different, you know, things they do offensive, a lot of moving parts to make you think one way and execute the other.
They come after the punt, and Tennessee gets it away cleanly.
Wow, this is how the game started.
40-yarder from Daniel. Josh Dobbs is our Capital One player of the game. 3 touchdowns on the ground, a new Music City Bowl record, 291 yards through the air. And I think the big thing that you touched on, he had an answer every time Nebraska was starting to get momentum.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Every time Nebraska started to creep back into this football game, Josh Dobbs quietly led his team down the field. And then there are a couple of occasions where big plays, the over-the-top toss, his lone touchdown pass of this game to Josh Malone, you know, really kind of put an exclamation point on it.
So another snap for Zach Darlington, the sophomore from Apopka, Florida, and he gets his first ever completion to Brandon Riley on the slant.
Talking about high school football, I know my trainer, high school trainer, Tim Wacker's watching this game. He's a loyal Husker alum. Say hi to Doc. He reached out to me through email this week, but there are better days ahead for the Huskers, that's for sure, under Mike Riley.
Sean Golden deflects that pass that was intended for Brandon Riley. So Nebraska down to Zach Darlington at quarterback. After Fife was sacked by Barnett, Darlington came in as a high school quarterback, battling numerous concussions his senior year playing for his dad down in Florida, moved to wide receiver this spring, and then once Tommy Armstrong got banged up, and in addition to that, they had the third stringer transfer going into this season. I said, hey, Zach, we need you back at quarterback, buddy, and I think the first sign. It is a chilly night here, and he's a Florida native, but the first sign is that he's playing quarterback with 2 gloves on.
Yeah, no doubt. It's a little chilly to get your first action and then to have it come deep into the fourth quarter.
Darlington lets one go deep. Trying to find Reimers. Well, for Butch Jones, it will end on a high note. A lot of people had fun with the Champions of Life comment that he made earlier this season. He is a master motivator, and when you're winning and you use those kinds of motivators, yep, kids react to it. When you lose,
I think it shows itself in the recruits, the class he's getting ready to sign.
Well, he's a champion of the living room, that's for sure. Another great recruiting class. Darren Kirkland Jr. with the big hit to close it out. Another turnover on down. Tennessee will go victory formation, and they will win the Music City Bowl and find their 9th win of the year, matching their win total from last season. They have gotten better each year in a Butch Jones or stayed the same. Back-to-back 9 win campaigns for a team that was picked to win the East this year. 3 straight bowl wins for the first time since the mid-90s when Peyton Manning was at quarterback. He's got some decisions to make. Revamp maybe parts of his coaching staff. Figure out how to get this program, say, back on track. They finished with 9 wins, but to meet the expectations of the fan base, and that's how his players feel about him.
Oh, yeah, he's feeling it. That ninth win. That ninth win feels good. Pour so much energy into this program, and had a long talk with him yesterday about recruiting and just the organization of the entire program, and I think they're in good hands with Butch Jones.
Once again, our final score from Nashville, Tennessee 38, Nebraska 24. Two tradition-rich programs meet in the postseason for the third time, and Tennessee tops Nebraska for the first of those meetings. Coming up next, it's a college football pregame show presented by H&R Block. Be sure to tune in to the postgame trophy ceremony presented by Capital One coming up next on ESPN3. A celebration for Tennessee senior Josh Dobbs and for Derek Barnett, the all-time school record in career sacks. It was all orange tonight here in Nashville. Tennessee finishes with a 9-win season, a 2-touchdown victory over Nebraska. For Cole Kublik, Andre Ware, our sensational crew here in Nashville, I'm Tom Hart. So long from the Music City. Hard rock.